CBS Radio Sports presents the National Football League AFC first-round playoff game between the Buffalo Bills and the New York Jets. Hello, everybody. I'm Dick Stockton, along with Lindsey Nelson, Jim Kelly, and Brent Musburger. Together, we'll bring you all the action and excitement of today's game, sponsored by Budweiser, by United Van Lines Moving Services, by Best Western Hotels, Motor Inns, and Resorts, and by Delco Electronics. New York is the pro football capital of this playoff Sunday as we welcome you to the first of two games on CBS Radio, getting the postseason underway on the road to the Super Bowl. Later today, the New York Giants play the Eagles in Philadelphia in the NFC first round battle. But coming up shortly, the Buffalo Bills take on the surprising New York Jets at Shea Stadium. The survivor moves on to a date with the Bengals in Cincinnati next Sunday. The Bills, with a shot at the AFC East title, lost to Miami last week and dropped to third place behind the Jets, who have the home field edge today. The Bills started impressively this season, fell off, and hit their low point in a 24-0 shellacking to St. Louis. At that point, the Bills were 6-5, but they got their second win and won four straight before losing to Miami in the finale. The Jets opened disastrously, dropping their first three before an amazing turnaround, winning seven, losing only one, and tying one before wrapping up a 10-5-1 campaign and their first visit to the playoffs since their dramatic Super Bowl triumph back in 1969. The Jets did it on the heels of an awesome pass rush. They called the New York sack exchange, and the rest fell into place. Meanwhile, the Bills, not quite up to their standard of a year ago, relied on overall balance on offense and a stingy, tenacious defense. This is the rubber match between the two. The Bills trounced the Jets 31-0 in the season opener in Buffalo. The Jets returned the favor 33-14 in mid-October. This game shapes up as a real grudge match since both clubs openly express their dislike for each other. And I'll have more details after this message.
The Texas Longhorns take on the Crimson Tide of Alabama in the Cotton Bowl New Year's Day. I'm Jack Buck, CBS Radio Sports. I'll be there in Dallas to call the play-by-play for you. Roman Gabriel will be alongside with his expert analysis. You're going to hear a lot of action, Texas against Alabama in the Cotton Bowl New Year's Day, beginning at 2 Eastern Time on most of these CBS Radio Network stations. Hear it here.
Parents, do you have a child who loves football? Your kid may be Super Pro material. Any boy or girl can join the NFL Super Pro Club. Members receive great surprises in the mail throughout the year, like team decals, an official Super Pro Club ID, NFL books, a Super Bowl 16 poster, and many other terrific things. Worth much more than a $6 membership fee. For your child's application, write NFL Super Pro Club, Box 9000, Trenton, New Jersey, 08650. Do it today.
When the Buffalo Bills have all the parts working in good order, they are as fine a machine as you'll find in the league. The problem this season has been an inconsistent attack, clearly evident last Sunday when they failed to score a touchdown against the Dolphins. The Bills use a balanced offense and prefer to control the ball. They have the ingredients with versatile running back Joe Cribbs, who can run inside or out and catch passes, and a set of receivers featuring record-breaking veteran Frank Lewis and underrated Jerry Butler. But the key for quarterback Joe Ferguson is getting time to operate, and that shapes up as the big question for Ferguson, who recognizes as well as anybody the pressure the Jets' formidable front four can apply.
Well, they have a fine pass rush, and they've improved over the last half of the season on their pass rush, but our offensive line has done a good job with it in the first two ball games, and I have confidence that they'll do another good job this week, and it's a situation where our two offensive tackles and offensive line knows their people, and they know our people, so it should be an interesting day for both parties.
No question these teams are familiar with each other down to the smallest detail, as Joe Ferguson describes, but the real heat will be on the Bills' offensive line, which must keep the pass rush away to some extent. If Ferguson gets in a groove, however, he can riddle the Jets. Defensively, the Bills, too, are known for their pass rush, but the Jets ran right at Buffalo last time out, and they were successful. The Bills' renowned Bermuda Triangle defense was not as potent this time around, partly due to Shane Nelson's injury, but the key man may be nose tackle Fred Smirlis up front. I'll be back with a look at the Jets in just a moment.
Ladies and gentlemen,
why don't you come down to the front row?
I don't have a ticket. ticket for the front row.
There's nobody there.
There's nobody else in here.
May I attract your attention?
To go on the radio.
You can't put a circus on the radio.
No, I mean advertise on the radio. Because not radio? Only is the cost of production on radio far less, but the commercials, once you get them finished, are easier to change your update.
For every town.
Change the name of the town. They can do that on radio.
We could have done this on the last 26 cities we were in.
Is that
in.
Where you've been? Average audience has been what?
You're it.
I'm it. Ah.
Hi.
How do you do?
This is the great Blondoni. He's going to do the high dive for you.
Radio will reach people. Get him in here. Watch the show.
I'm not going into that bat of wet noodles for one guy.
I'll give you a dollar.
But he gave me a dollar. That's how you got in.
No, I live next door. I snuck in.
Oh. Radio. Red hot. Because it works. When your business needs more paying customers, advertise on radio. It's flexible and cost efficient. The Radio Advertising Bureau can send you more facts. This station can send you more customers.
Everybody's been talking about the New York Jets pass rush, and well, they should. Mark Gastineau, Abdul Salam, Marty Lyons, and Joe Klecko are the names of the now famous New York Sack Exchange, who have helped make the Jets the top defensive team in the AFC. But the Jets have come alive on offense as well, thanks to a maturing quarterback, Richard Todd, and two speed burners outside in Wesley Walker, who is physically okay now, and Lamb Jones, who is finally paying dividends. Buffalo's biggest weakness on defense in the second game against the Jets was against the run, so New York likely will call on the likes of rookie Freeman McNeil early to set up the passing game. Still, the key to anything the Jets accomplish rests with the defense, and in particular, the front four. So one of the important matchups we'll find left defensive end Gastineau going up against Bills right tackle Joe Devlin, and that battle may tell a lot. It's been 12 years between playoffs, and the one Jet who remembers the last one is guard Randy Rasmussen, who recalled what it was like then in the Super Bowl of 1969 and now.
The thing I remember most about the first time was the fact it was so easy. You know, I joined the Jets in 1967. In 68, we were in the playoffs, won the Super Bowl. In 69, we were in the playoffs again, and it seemed very easy. You know, it seemed like something we'd do every year. And then we went through the bad years, years when we were 4-10 and couldn't beat anybody, and you kind of got the feeling you wondered if you'd ever be back there again. And we're finally back in it again, and it's a tremendous feeling. And I think this time around, I appreciate it a lot more.
The Jets' Randy Rasmussen, back with my final comments in 60 seconds.
Has problems, that is true, but here's our season's wish for you. The peace and goodwill just might yet work. Season's cheer from the CBS Radio Network.
With that word of cheer from CBS News correspondent Charles Osgood, greetings of the season from the Spectrum Six. Pat O'Brien, Roger Wilkins, Joe Sobran, Jack Newfield, Marianne Means, and Kevin Phillips. Holiday greetings, too, from Ida LeShad, Marshall Lowe, Bob Keeshan, and Lee Jordan. From Steve Birnbaum and Steve Scheuer, Shep Campbell, Nick Seitz, and Jack Sampson. And from everyone else at the CBS Radio Network.
So we're all set for the Bills and the Jets coming right up. Obviously, the Bills have burned the midnight oil, trying to devise ways of nullifying the Jets' pass rush, because if they do, the Bills' experience, having been in the postseason, could be a factor against the inexperienced Jets. However, the Bills admit they don't like playing in Shea Stadium, and that could work to the Jets' advantage. That, and the fact that since those three opening losses, the Jets have a tremendous record of 10-2-1. Not that these teams need any added incentive, but the rivalry between the two is genuine, and that makes for a terrific opening playoff matchup. Later today, Giants and Eagles, but in just 1 minute, we'll be going to Lindsey Nelson and Jim Kelly in Shea Stadium for football action. Until next time, this is Dick Stockton, CBS Radio Sports.
Shea Stadium in New York on the CBS Radio Network and around the world with American Forces Radio. CBS Radio presents the AFC first-round playoff game, the visiting Buffalo Bills challenging the New York Jets. Hello, everybody, and season's greetings. I'm Jim Kelly, Lindsey Nelson alongside, and together we'll bring you all the action and excitement of today's game. Brent Musburger joins us at halftime. The Buffalo Bills not bullish on the New York sack exchange this weekend. The Bills lead the original AFL series 24-20. They are meeting for the 45th time in the regular season. The two teams split this year, Buffalo winning the season opener in Buffalo 31-0. The Jets triumphing here at Shea Stadium 7 weeks ago, 33-14. For the first time, however, in the history of these two franchises, both original members of the American Football League, the Buffalo Bills and the New York Jets meet in a playoff game. Now, by sending the Green Bay Packers packing 28-3 last Sunday, the Jets moved past the Bills into second place in the final AFC standings. New York finished with a record of 10 wins, 5 losses, and 1 tie, while Buffalo was a 16-6 loser in Saturday's division championship test at the Orange Bowl in Miami, and they wound up with a record of 10-6. The two previous New York-Buffalo meetings this season were strikingly dissimilar, the Bills winning the first game 31-0, busting it wide open with a 21-point third quarter in which the Bills scored on each of their first three possessions. 6 weeks later, however, at Shea Stadium here in New York, the Jets used a 21-point third quarter to deal the Bills a 33-14 setback. The key matchup in this afternoon's playoff game between the New York Herald and Sack Exchange, which dumped quarterbacks in NFL record times of 66 in 1981, and the Buffalo offensive line. And now to honor America, our national anthem. Presented by authority of the National Football League and is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this broadcast without the express written consent of the New York Jets and the National Football League is prohibited. We're at Shea Stadium in New York, the Bills playing host, or the Jets playing host to the Buffalo Bills. We'll be back in one moment.
Has problems, that is true, but here's our season's wish for you. The peace and goodwill just might yet work. Season's cheer from the CBS Radio Network.
With that word of cheer from CBS News correspondent Charles Osgood, we bring you greetings from some people you know. Dan Rather, Mike Wallace, George Herman, Morley Safer, Harry Reasoner, Leslie Stahl, and Neil Strausser. Rob Armstrong, John Bohannon, Judy Muller, Paul Lockwood, Jerry Landay, Stephanie Shelton, Bob Schieffer, and Doug Poley. And from everyone else at the CBS Radio Network.
Jim Kelly, Lindsey Nelson back at Shea Stadium. The New York Jets have won the toss and have elected to receive. We'll set the stage for you this afternoon. We started talking about the key matchup. Usually in playoff games, there are great individual matchups. We have those, but there are team matchups as well. Specifically, the sack exchange, the New York Jets and their defensive front, which has sacked quarterbacks in the NFL a record 66 times this year. And, of course, the Buffalo offensive line for the second year in a row, the league's most proficient at protecting the passer, in the Buffalo case, Joe Ferguson. The Bills permitting only 16 sacks all season long. However, three of those sacks came in the two games against the New York Jets. Now let's pause 5 seconds for our stations to identify themselves on the CBS Radio Network.
You're listening to WROW Albany.
The only edge the Buffalo Bills might have in this game, well, you might think it would be the passing of Joe Ferguson to his outstanding wide receivers, Jerry Butler and Frank Lewis. However, that should be negated by the New York Jets and the home field advantage. The Jets come in having won 8 games in a row. Buffalo comes in the playoffs on a rather sour note. A very sad, lackluster 16-6 loss to the Dolphins down in Miami. For the play-by-play, the man who for so many years was here at Shea Stadium broadcasting the New York Jets and thought he had seen every nook and cranny until today.
Thank you very much, Jim Kelly. Hello again, everybody. Nick McNamara sees the ball up on the 35. Bruce Harper's dropped back with Kurt Sohn to receive the kickoff for the New York Jets. Here comes McNamara. Toe meets the ball. The kick is end over end, and Harper is waiting at the 6-yard line. Straight upfield to the 10, bears right to the 15, to the 20, past the 25, fumbles the ball, picked up by Buffalo, and it is being streaked into the end zone. Touchdown for Buffalo as it was picked up by Charles Rome at about the 25-yard line, and he carried it into the end zone for a touchdown. Harper fumbled, returning the opening kickoff. Rome recovered, took it in there for the touchdown. So quickly, the Buffalo Bills are on the scoreboard. Conversion attempt coming now.
Actually, Harper was hit by number 50 of the Buffalo Bills first, Mike Humston, and then the ball was stripped loose. Rome's fielded the ball at about the 25-yard line. There wasn't a jet nearby, so the Bills silenced this sold-out Shea Stadium crowd.
Conversion attempt coming now by McNamara. He is poised and waiting. McNamara boots. It is up, and it's good. And so the Buffalo Bills have scored 7 points very quickly here this afternoon at Shea Stadium. And with the score, Buffalo 7, the Jets nothing, let's take time out.
This bud's for all the men in black and white. Yeah, to the guys who always have the last word, here's to the referee.
This bud's for you. There's no one else who does it quite the way you do. So here's to you. You know it is, it's only what you say, it's what you do.
Just for you guys who blow the whistle and fling the flags, here's that distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
I don't always agree with them, Jack, but where would we be without them?
Well, sometimes you'd be about 15 yards closer to the goal line.
This Bud's for you, for all you do, the king of beers is coming through.
You deserve it, refs, so take time out after the game for a cold Bud. It just might be your best call all day.
For all you do.
Bud's for you.
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis.
Charles Rome's 26 yards for the Buffalo Bills. The first touchdown the Bills have gotten all year long on a fumble return. Surprisingly, Lindsey, the New York Jets ranked third in the NFL in turnovers all year. Cincinnati with 24, San Francisco with 25, the Jets with 27. Usually, the visiting team likes to silence the crowd with a long, sustained ball possession kind of a drive, but the Bills did it very quickly.
They did it very quickly, and now they'll kick it off again. McNamara is teed up on the 35-yard line. Harper's still back there. Deep with Sohn to receive the kickoff. Here comes McNamara. Ball is up, and it's in the air. Sailing downfield over to Harper's side again. He's at the 7-yard line. Harper to the 10, to the 15, to the 20. Across the 25, and he is thrown back there. They'll start first and 10 at the 25-yard line. So now the New York Jets get first possession. That tackle was made by Irvin Parker. Richard Todd coming out now with the troops. He's got Tom Newton at fullback, Freeman McNeil at running back. Wesley Walker starting at a wide receiver, and Derek Gaffney starting at a wide receiver, and Jerome Barkham is the tight end. Wide receiver left as they break the huddle and come up here. Now they send a wide receiver right. That's Gaffney. Running backs are evened up. Todd is waiting. Todd dropping back. Throws out left. And it's second out there at about the 30-yard line. A completed pass, Wesley Walker, the receiver, for the first pass completion of the day at the 31-yard line. That's a gain of 6 yards.
Just a simple down and out pattern for Walker, who came in as the second favorite receiver of Richard Todd. 47 catches, 770 yards on the season, averaging about 16 and a half yards per catch, 9 touchdowns for Walker. He's a speed burner.
Kevin Long is in there. Kevin Long and Tom Newton will be shuttling players in and out all afternoon, presumably. Gaffney's set on a slot right now. Freeman McNeil is in the left set. Here it goes to Kevin Long. And Long gets just past the line of scrimmage, picked up about a yard, and he's thrown back by the defensive right shot of the Buffalo Bills. Smirlis was the first to get to him.
Smirlis, of course, is the key in that so-called Bermuda Triangle that the Bills have. A lot of heated words were exchanged all week long in the press between the two defensive units, the sack exchange of the New York Jets and the Bermuda Triangle of the Buffalo Bills. These two teams don't like each other a whole lot.
Third down and 3 yards to go at the 32 now. Newton is back in there at the fullback. Todd dropping back to take a look. He sets it up, throws left, and it is caught out there at about the line of scrimmage.
Pass is completed to Scott Durking. He's brought down by Jim Haslett.
Durking took the pass and was trying to struggle for it, but couldn't get the first down yardage, so the punting unit is coming on. Chuck Ramsey's coming in to do the punting.
Richard Todd had all kinds of pass protection that time, plenty of time. However, the secondary did their job and covered the primary receivers. Todd had to dump it off to Durking, who was the safety valve, number 25, thrown down by Isaiah Robertson, number 58, 11 years out of Southern. Of course, he played for Chuck Knox for a while at the Los Angeles Rams.
Ramsey has averaged 40.6 on his kicks this year. His long is 65. Lou Pecone has dropped back with Riddick to receive it. Low snap, but Ramsey gets it off. And Riddick is moving up. He takes it at the 28-yard line. He's at the 30. Bounces off right, still struggling. Riddick now is pulled down hard at about the 32-yard line. A 40-yard punt by Ramsey. So the Buffalo Bills get the ball. They get it first and 10. Tackle was made by Mario Clark. And they'll have it on their own 32-yard line. Penalty marker. And they're checking that one out. It's way back downfield. On the left side.
You know, Lindsey, Rob Riddick, the rookie out of Millersville State in Pennsylvania, almost broke that one. They had the wall set up for him over on the right side. However, had Johnny Lynn not thrown him down, the second-year former Bruin out of UCLA, they did have the wall set up for him absolutely perfectly.
Penalty was against the Jets. It's been declined, and so the Bills will start at first and 10, a timeout taken here, and we'll be back in just a moment.
This is Gene King for your Better Business Bureau. The new game seems to be the electronic one. Video and portable electronic games have suddenly taken hold. And the Better Business Bureau offers this advice. Do a lot of comparison shopping because costs vary both with complexity and with the manufacturer. Play a wide variety of games, too, and find out which ones you prefer and then read your warranty carefully. Most electronic games come with limited warranties, but some don't. If yours doesn't, check out the store's repair and exchange policies. The availability of repairs should play an important part in your choice, as should the additional expenses of different so-called software packages. But most importantly, buy your game from a reputable dealer where you can count on the staff's knowledge and service. A tip from your Better Business Bureau.
Jim Kelly, Lindsey Nelson back at Shea Stadium, where they tell us the winds are swirling from the east-northeast at about 18 miles per hour. They tell us it is 34 degrees at game time. However, it is much colder down on the playing field where the winds continue to swirl. Buffalo has the ball for the first time in the football game offensively after scoring on that 26-yard touchdown fumble recovery by Charles Rome.
Here they are up there now. Ferguson waiting for the snap, running back to an eye formation, leaks ahead of Cribbs, running wide receivers left and right. Ferguson dropping back, sets now, throws to Butler on the right side. Butler makes the catch, is hit immediately up there about the 38-yard line. It was Darrell Ray who came up from his free safety to make the hit immediately. Get him about 6 yards on the play, make it second down and 4 now for the Buffalo Bills.
Number 80, Jerry Butler, third-year man out of Clemson. The Tigers, of course, ranked number one at the end of the college football season. The second favorite receiver of Joe Ferguson. 55 catches, 842 yards, averaging about 15 yards per catch. 8 touchdowns. The Bills want to establish ball possession early. They'll do it with the running of Joe Cribbs and the short passes by Joe Ferguson.
Wide receivers left and right. The running backs are well split. And here's a handoff. It is straight into the line this time. And coming in to make the tackle is Gastineau. Cribbs carried just on a straight dive play as Ferguson was sliding down the line, and he picked up about a yard. So it'll be third down coming up. And about 4 yards to go.
Big Mark Gastineau, number 99. He is 6'5", 276 in his third year out of East Central Oklahoma. He, of course, a key of that New York sack exchange on the one side, along with Joe Klecko out of Temple.
Now they go into the shotgun. Ferguson in position to get a direct snap. He's flanked left and right. Wide receivers extended left and right. Third down and 4 yards to go. Ferguson gets the snap, drops back and looks. Throws long to Butler, to Cribbs, and it's incomplete. Batted incomplete, intended for Cribbs down there on the 45-yard line. Greg Buttle going back into defense, had it deflected, and the punting unit is coming on now for Buffalo. The hand is for the Jets defense.
A poor throw by Joe Ferguson. He threw it high. He released a little soon. Number 28, Darrell Ray, the free safety, second-year man out of Oklahoma, former Sooner, 6'1", 206, was over there, had the ball in his grasp, batted it up once, and just couldn't hang on. It's very cold, damp, windy, and chilly here at Shea Stadium.
Greg Cater's back in deep punt formation. Harper's dropped back, standing on his own 20 to receive it for the Jets. There is the snap. Cater steps up, gets the boot off. Long, high, spiraling kick. Harper's moving over. He's back now at the 16-yard line. Runs right to the 20. Hits short the sideline to the 25. Tries to cut back to the inside and struggles just short of the 30-yard line. So it was a 47-yard punt by Cater. And they will start now. The Jets will first and 10 with the score. Buffalo 7, the Jets nothing. Let's take timeout.
Hello?
You're on.
Hello?
Yes, how can I help you?
Well, I was feeling kind of depressed, so I thought I'd cheer myself up, you know, buy a new car, maybe get a...
No names, please.
Of course, I had trouble making decisions even before all the imports.
Sir, on this program, I try to help.
But I've only test-driven 317 cars.
Well, I find in life you must not just drive, not just look at, but listen to a new car.
Can you give me that again?
Please pay attention. In a more meaningful audio relationship, if a person would have, for example, test-listened...
Test-listened?
...to a General Motors car equipped with the Delco GM stereo.
Yeah.
He would have searched inward and found his General Motoring outlook brightened.
Yeah,
let me finish. Delco GM is the leading auto sound specialist. They made the first car stereo.
Now, wait a minute, lady. You're suggesting I cheer myself up by buying, say, a new Chevrolet just so
I don't think we should limit ourselves to one particular car division in life.
But
we can also hear great Delco GM sound in Pontiacs, Buicks, Oldsmobiles, Cadillacs, and GMC trucks.
I thought you said no names, please.
And thanks for calling.
Jim Kelly, Lindsey Nelson back at Shea Stadium in New York. Buffalo leads at 7-0. A fumble recovery, run in for a touchdown, the difference.
And now they just put the running backs. They've got Kevin Long in there at the fullback now. Freeman McNeil is the running back. Todd has the ball. Gives it to Kevin Long, and he tries the right side. Gets across the 30. Struggles up to the 33-yard line for a gain of 3. It'll be second down, 7 yards to go. Jets ball on their own 33. Ben Williams in to make the tackle for the Buffalo Bills. Members of the Jets championship team are here in reunion this afternoon. We had a chance to visit with some of them before the ball game as they were making their way around the stadium renewing old acquaintances.
The big mystery is whether or not Joe Namath is here.
That's the mystery. Fella tapped me on the shoulder, said, I haven't seen you since El Paso. It was Don Maynard, who played with both the Giants and the Jets. Second down, 7 yards to go. Todd back, throws out to the left side, and it's incomplete. Forward pass behind the line. For attempting an incompleted pass. Freeman McNeil, the intended receiver.
Richard Todd now 2 out of 3 in the passing department for just 7 yards. He really, except for the initial pass catch by their wide receiver Wesley Walker, has not tested the Buffalo secondary, has not gone deep. Jets are attending to number 79 over on the sidelines. That is Marvin Powell, 6'5", 270, his fifth year out of Southern California.
John Roman has replaced him now at the tackle position. Third and 7. Harper's in there in place of Freeman McNeil at the moment. Todd dropping back to throw. He sets it up, gets it off just in time, and it's gathered in by Jerome Barkham. And Barkham is going out of bounds at the 30-yard line. the tight end Jerome Barkham with his first reception of the day. And the Jets have moved the ball first and 10 to the Buffalo 30-yard line.
Big play time for Richard Todd, and he did it in the grasp of Ben Williams, number 77. The six-year Ole Miss grad was coming in from the left side. And Todd just did well to get rid of the ball. Great grab by Barkham. First down, their deepest penetration so far at the Bills' 30-yard line. That's the initial first down of the football game for the New York Jets.
37-yard pickup on the completed pass play. Barkham is coming off the field, and he's being replaced by Mickey Shuler, who's coming on just now. Todd has convened the huddle now. First and 10 at the Buffalo 30-yard line. Buffalo leading 7-0. We're in the first quarter at Shea Stadium in New York. Wesley Walker coming out to a wide right now. They've got Derek Gaffney in the slot right. Todd with the ball. Back to set up. Throws long. And it's Wesley Walker. Incomplete. A yard deep in the end zone. It was off his fingertips and incomplete.
Simply the deep post pattern from the 30-yard line. And Walker was wide open. He had 9 touchdown catches coming into this game, as we told you earlier, averaging about 16 and a half yards. He beat his man, number 29, Mario Clark, to the inside. Clark, in his 6th year out of Oregon, was beaten badly by about 3 yards, and it hit Wesley Walker right in the numbers and bounced off his shoulder pads, incomplete. Todd now 3 out of 5 for 44 yards.
Second down, 10 yards to go, ball at the 30-yard line. Newton is coming at fullback now. He is bringing the plays in. He and Kevin Long are alternating in. Todd dropping back, handing it off. It's down to Freeman McNeil, but he can't go, and he's thrown back there at the 34-yard line for a loss of 4. So it'll be third down and 14 yards to go for the Jets, who are trailing by 7 points here in the first quarter.
Lindsey, you know, the Buffalo Bills, Chuck Knox, they have to be concerned. They did not play well a week ago in the Orange Bowl against Don Shula's Dolphins, losing 16-6. And David Woodley, who is a young quarterback and just learning, pretty well picked the Bills' secondary apart. Richard Todd, a much more accomplished quarterback for the New York Jets with a 56% completion ratio, 279 completions, 497 attempts. And Todd is going to have a field day here unless the Bills can shore up that secondary.
Harper and Durkin, both good receivers, are in the ballgame now. Todd has the ball. He evades one tackler, throws deep, and it's Walker incomplete in the end zone. Walker racing 5 yards deep into the end zone, but was overthrown. Jeff Nixon was covering defensively.
Kenny Johnson, 91, 6'5", 253 in his 3rd year out of Knoxville College, putting all kinds of pressure on Richard Todd in the backfield. Todd did a little stutter step, got away from him. Meanwhile, Walker did the hook and go down at about the 15-yard line. The safety man came up and took the fake, but that time Todd was chased out of the pocket and had thrown it about 3 yards beyond the waiting grasp of Wesley Walker. A long incompletion, so Pat Leahy will try about a 52 or 53-yarder.
52, we'll call it, and his longest of the year is 49. He boots, it's carrying, and it is a little short underneath the crossbar, so the ball will go over at the line of scrimmage to the Buffalo Bills, as the 7-point margin for the Buffalo Bills is intact on the missed field goal attempt of 52 yards. So with the score, Buffalo 7, the Jets nothing, let's take timeout.
If we were to tell you all the things you get when you buy a Buick Riviera, you might find it a little hard to believe.
An all-expense-paid vacation?
Not quite.
Well, then what?
Well, how about power windows, power seats, electric door locks, air conditioning, cruise control, automatic transmission with overdrive?
All that on one car?
Uh-huh, and more.
I couldn't be more impressed.
Bet you could. See the Riviera. It's unbelievable.
Wouldn't you really rather have a Buick?
On a great football team, everything blends together perfectly. So does a great meal. Take the braised sirloin tips at Denny's restaurants, for example. We slice the tender tips from lean sirloin steak, braise them to seal in their flavor, smother them in rich mushroom gravy, simmer them gently, then ladle them over Durham flour egg noodles. Braised sirloin tips, only $2.99 till the end of January at Denny's, where you'll like our prices and you'll love our food.
Jets training staff attending to Jerome Barkham over on the New York sideline. He had a 17-yard grab that gave the Buffalo Bills a big first, or gave the New York Jets a big first down. Jerome Barkham, number 83, their big tight end. Bills defense held. Leahy missed from 52 by just about a yard and a half. It was right on line, but under the crossbar. So the Buffalo Bills leading 7-0 have good field position up at the 34-yard line.
They break the huddle now. They're sending Lewis to the right side, Butler to the left side, running back to an eye formation. Roosevelt leaks ahead of Joe Cribbs. Ferguson is waiting for the snap. Buffalo wearing the white jerseys with the blue numerals. He's got the ball. Ferguson has dropped back. Goes out to the right side to Lewis. Lewis has got it. He's at the 45 and he's getting up toward midfield. Run out of bounds at the 48-yard line. Greg Buddle ran him out over there. It's a first and 10. Lewis with his first catch of the day. First down for the Buffalo Bills.
And my, oh my, what a hit. Number 73, Joe Klecko, put on Joe Ferguson. He's in his fifth year out of Temple. Ferguson never saw him. He was coming in from Ferguson's left side. Pass went away and a completion for the initial Buffalo Bills first down. Ferguson gets up a little slowly.
Here come the Buffalo Bills once again, sending Lewis out to the right side and Jerry Button to the left. The running backs are still in an I formation. Quarterback Joe Ferguson waiting there for the snap. He's got it. The handoff goes to Cribbs. He tries the middle and is stacked up just as he crossed the 50-yard line. It's going to be marked at the 50, so it's again a 2 yards to make it second down and 8 yards to go. Larry Mill in to make the tackle. Linebacker for the New York Jets.
Interesting that we have played now almost half of the first quarter, and that is Joe Cribbs' first possession of the football game. Cribbs, the leading ground gainer, of course, 257 carries, 1,097 yards, averaging about 4.5 yards. Three touchdowns on the year for Joe Cribbs.
Again, it's Lewis to the right side and Butler wide to the left side this time. The running backs are evened up for Joe Ferguson. Ferguson now dropping back to look. Throws to Lewis, and Lewis has got it. He's at the 30-yard line, 25-20, 15-10, heading for the flag. Touchdown for the Buffalo Bills. A 50-yard touchdown pass to Lewis for the touchdown.
Frank Lewis, very deceiving. His 11th year out of Grambling has been around for a while. 6'1", 196. Ferguson with a hot hand. Lewis, however, is the favorite receiver of Ferguson with four touchdowns coming in. So that's number five on the year. Excellent pass protection by that Buffalo offensive line. They've been controlling things so far, and the Bills have struck quickly twice in a row. They lead it 13-0, 7:57 left to go in quarter number one.
Dick Mickemeyer is in to attempt the conversion now. Matt Robinson will hold for him. Crowd is quiet here at Shea Stadium for the moment, having seen Buffalo take the early lead. Now Mickemeyer is poised. Ball is put down. He boots it up, and it's good. And so, as they come back up the field, the Buffalo Bills have gone out ahead of the New York Jets by a score of 14-0 here with 7 minutes 57 seconds remaining to be played in the first quarter at Shea Stadium in New York.
Lindsey said the crowd was quiet. Stunned might be a better word. 7:57 to go. The Buffalo Bills go 66 yards. They do it in just three plays. But, of course, the big one, the touchdown catch by Lewis, who just simply outran the New York Jets secondary. Only four more weeks until the Super Bowl. And our team, Dick Stockton, Brent Musburger, Hank Stram, and Jack Buck, will be at the Silverdome in Pontiac, Michigan, when the top NFL teams meet to decide the championship. The Super Bowl, better catch it. Mark down the date, Sunday, January the 24th. Hear it here from CBS Radio Sports. And speaking of Jack Buck and Hank Stram, they're at a rather cold, chilly, and windy Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia this afternoon. Philadelphia Eagles will play host to the New York Giants, and that'll be the second half of our doubleheader coming up here at 3:15 Eastern Time, right here on CBS Radio.
There is football fever all over New York today. It's the most excitement we've seen at this time of year among the football fans for years and years, because both of the New York teams, of course, are in the playoffs. It'll be a kickoff now for the Buffalo Bills. Ball is teed on the 35-yard line. Harper's gone back with Kurt Sohn to receive the kickoff. He walks over to say something to Sohn. Bruce Harper, who fumbled the opening kickoff of the ball game, that was returned for the Buffalo touchdown. Bruce, Bob McElwee is the referee here this afternoon. We are waiting for his whistle. That will send Mickemeyer forward with the kickoff here now. And there it is. Here comes Mickemeyer. Sailing downfield. Harper moves up. He's got it at the 9-yard line. To the 10, goes right to the 15, to the 20. Across the 25, and is hit down at about the 27-yard line. Harper on the run back, and he is hit by Rod Cush. An 18-yard return, and so it'll be first down and 10 yards to go now for the Jets, who get the support of the crowd. The ball is taken inbounds, and it's marked at the 29-yard line.
Crowd starting to exhort the local New York Jets. Lindsey, I don't know if it's an omen of any kind. The Jets actually outscored their opponents 355 to 287. The Jets allowed the fewest number of points, however, in the entire NFL in the first quarter, 37 over the course of 16 games, but they've given up 14 here in the first half of the first quarter.
Newton and Freeman McNeil are the setbacks. Ball is handed out to McNeil. He tries right tackle, drives across the 30 yards to the 32, 33-yard line. Ben Williams in to make the tackle for Buffalo. Collie to gain of 4 yards, and that'll make it second down and six. Coming in with the next play now is Kevin Long. Jerome Barkham is back in the ballgame. Barkham apparently had a cramp. It was worked on along the sideline, and now he's back in the game. Barkham, as a matter of fact, comes out of the huddle and takes a position as a wide right here. Second and six. Penalty marker thrown on the snap. So we have a penalty to be enforced.
One of the Jets jumped off sides. That's the first penalty of the football game against the New York Jets for a total of 5 yards. Lindsey, the Jets seem a little bit tentative. We said coming in at the top of the broadcast that
it... Number 76, defense, second down.
Smirlis, offside for Buffalo.
That's right. From our vantage point, the referee does not face us. I'm starting to say the Jets seem a little bit tentative. The Bills with the playoff experience, it's been 12 years since the New York Jets team has been into any kind of a playoff game.
Second down and a yard to go. Tied back to throw, throws left, and it's deflected incomplete.
Almost intercepted by Isaiah Robertson, number 58.
The He's ball unhappy.
He was actually closer to the ball than Wesley Walker was. You know, you talk about the city of New York being excited because both the Jets and the Giants are in the playoffs. It's been 12 years since the Jets have been in, and one of the local telecasters on TV last night was saying, you know, if you've got a son or a daughter 18 years old, it's been that long since the Giants have been in. They haven't had a playoff contender in 18 years.
It has been a long dry spell. Here it is, third down and a yard to go now. Scott Durking is in there, good receiver. Running back. Waiting for is in there, good receiver, veteran running back. Waiting for the snap now is Richard Todd, the quarterback from the University of Alabama. He is back and setting up on a third and one. He goes to the left side and it is a diving catch is made for the first down. Barkham was hit immediately and he is down at the 40-yard line. Or is that a Buffalo man who is down?
That's Jerome. Charles Rome, who has the touchdown, the fumble off the touchdown off the fumble. Charlie Rome, number 26. He hit Barkham as soon as the ball arrived. Barkham was up in midair. Todd again with excellent protection. Had time to give it to fake. Barkham came down with it and picked up the first down. And Rome rolled over right away, and they are attending to him down at the 40-yard line of the New York Jets.
We have 6 minutes, 53 seconds remaining to be played now in the first quarter. With Buffalo leading by a score of 14 to nothing, and this is an injury timeout. With Rome still down there on the 40-yard line. Make it a New Year's resolution to hear the Cotton Bowl game this Friday. The University of Texas Longhorns go up against the Crimson Tide of Alabama beginning at 2 p.m. Eastern Time. Jack Buck and Roman Gabriel will be there for all the action. The Cotton Bowl this Friday on CBS Radio. Hear it here.
You'll head for Dallas after this game. You've got it on CBS television. How many years have you done the Cotton Bowl?
This will be the 22nd year, which means I've spent 22 New Year's Eves in Dallas, Texas.
Chuck Knox, the head coach of the Buffalo Bills, with that 14-point lead. If there's a knock against Chuck Knox, it is the fact that his team has not fared too well in the playoffs. Some people say they are slow finishers. Chuck Knox, 3 wins, 6 losses in playoff games with some much stronger Los Angeles Rams teams than Buffalo in the last couple of years. You look at head-to-head matchups, so we'll talk about that in a second.
First and 10 at the 42 now. McNeil is in the tailback in the IR formation. Todd up
to hang on, but dropped the ball just inches off the ground, and it bounced right up, so it's incomplete out there about the 50-yard line.
That's the first poor pass that Todd has thrown. Richard is 4 out of 9 for 50 yards in the afternoon. We started to talk about head-to-head matchups between Chuck Knox and Walt Michaels. Chuck Knox has won 5 out of 6 from Walt. These two coaches both began their pro career, ironically, back on the original New York Jets staff in 1963 when Webb Eubank was the head coach.
Second and 10 at the 42, and Charles Rhomes has come back into the ballgame at a right cornerback for the Buffalo Bills. Kevin Long is in there at the fullback. He'll be shuttling in all day. Long's got the ball. He hits in and gets across the 45 up to the 50-yard line. Looks to be about a yard short of the first down, possibly two. Kevin Long carrying, and he goes off. He hits back to the huddle now, but he will come off because Tom Newton is brought in the next play.
Kevin Long was the fifth leading rusher on the Jet team with two touchdowns, 73 carries, 269 yards. Earned a game ball in the game against the Cleveland Browns with his outstanding running and blocking when the Jets hung onto the ball in the final 4.5 minutes of that football game and protected that one-point lead.
Third down and 2 yards to go. Ball is at the 50-yard line. He's got Durkings in there. Durkings got the ball. He's got the first down. He's through to the 45, to the 40. Penalty marker at the line of scrimmage. A penalty marker thrown by the head linesman, who is Leo Miles. Illegal motion. So that will nullify what would have otherwise been a first down.
Walt Michael over on the Jets sideline, scratching his head in disgust at that one.
Illegal motion, number 82, offense, third down.
Yeah, we're talking about Walt Michaels and Chuck Knox. Both are total fundamentalists, and their basic offenses are very much alike. The big difference is that Chuck Knox has been using the shotgun on offense the last 2 years, and he stays with a basic 3-4 defense. The Jets play a 4-3 defense all the way, and when you've got that sack exchange, why not?
Third down and 7 yards to go. Back at the 45 now. Running backs are well split. Todd waits for the snap. Going to a high count now. Gets the ball. Drops back. Sets up. Throws left. And it's intercepted at the 40-yard line. Return to the 50. 45. And streaking down the sideline. The Buffalo Bills in possession once again. Return it all the way to the 12-yard line.
Rufus Best, number 28, his third year out of South Carolina State. The man who came up with the interception. Actually, the wide receiver turned it inside. The ball was thrown outside. And Rufus Best, a 48-yard return. And that's another turnover against the New York Jets, who are crippling themselves with interceptions and fumbles so far this afternoon. Ironically, that's the first interception of the season after 16 games for Rufus Best. And as far as Richard Todd is concerned, that is interception number 14 on the year, and a great return. And it was Richard Todd who finally made the tackle. Otherwise, that would have gone for a touchdown.
Now the Buffalo Bills, first and 10. They have the ball at the 12-yard line. Lewis comes out of the huddle out to the right side and Butler to the left side. Ferguson handing it off. Roosevelt Leakes tries to go to the left side, but he's cut off by the Jet defense. He was trying to sweep left, but couldn't find any place to go. An official standing between two players over on the left side now, as tempers were flaring just for the moment. Ball is at the 11-yard line. It'll be second down and 9 at the 11 for the Buffalo Bills. This time they are doubling Butler and Lewis to the right side. They split Cribbs and Roosevelt Leakes. Cribbs in the right set and Leakes in the left. Joe Ferguson, the quarterback, dropping back to take a look now. Throws to Lewis in the right corner, and it's deflected incomplete at the last moment.
Jerry Holmes, number 47, in his second year out of West Virginia, had one interception this year, batted that ball away just at the last second. That was simply a corner route. And again, excellent pass protection afforded Ferguson by the Buffalo Bills offensive line.
It'll be third down and 9 at the 11-yard line now. Here come the Buffalo Bills. The crowd trying to exhort the defense of the New York Jets. Ron Jesse is in the slot right. Here in the shotgun. Ferguson waiting for the direct snap, and he's got it. Dropping back to look. And throws to the left side, and it's incomplete. Diving attempt made. Down in the corner by Cribbs. He couldn't get to it. So it'll be fourth down coming up.
That would have been a remarkable touchdown for the Buffalo Bills. The ball was thrown on a rope by Ferguson, who was going down, cast backwards by number 74, Abdul Salam, 6'3", 269, in his sixth year out of Kent State. Ferguson looking right the whole way. Salam had him down around the ankles, but not in the grasp, in the opinion of the referee. And somehow, Ferguson found Joe Cribbs streaking down the left sideline, and Cribbs almost came up with a remarkable catch off truly a remarkable throw by Ferguson.
Now it's going to be a 29-yard field goal attempt by Pat Leahy. I beg your pardon. By Mickemeyer, and Mickemeyer boots it, and it is good. 29-yard field goal by Nick Mickemeyer is good. Three more points for the Buffalo Bills. And so they run it up now 17-0. We're still in the first quarter here at Shea Stadium. Buffalo Bills and the New York Jets, both in the Eastern Division, the American Football Conference, but neither of them won it because the Miami Dolphins were the winners in the Eastern Division. Last week when the Jets won their finale, they moved ahead of Buffalo and finished second as Miami and Buffalo were playing in Miami for the championship, actually. Big crowd, of course, arrived early this morning here at Shea Stadium. The New York is coming out to see the Jets in playoff action, but they have been sorely disappointed so far because it's been the Buffalo Bills from New York State, of course, themselves, who have rolled it up so far 17-0 in the first quarter. Going back there deep is Bruce Harper, and Kurt Sohn is joining him, and Mickemeyer again will kick it off from the 35-yard line.
Lindsey, again, the Jets appear awfully tentative both offensively and defensively. Obviously, the fumble and the interception is hurt, but the Bills seem to be showing their playoff experience, their playoff poise early in the first quarter.
That they do. Mickemeyer is checking with the official now, raises his hand. Bob McElwee blows the whistle, and here comes Mickemeyer. And Harper moves up. He's got it at the 11-yard line. To the 15, runs right to the 20, to the 25. Across the 30-yard line and goes out of bounds. So the Jets get relatively good field position once again on the return, as it was Vogler who ran him out of bounds. He's taken to the inbounds marker and spotted. It'll be first down and 10 yards to go at the 33-yard line.
Total yards so far in the football game, the Buffalo Bills 72, the New York Jets 62, but a big deficit obviously in the scoreboard, what with that 17-point lead for the Buffalo Bills.
Rome's is in there at the cornerback. As we told you a moment ago, the report on him was that he was simply winded. He had the wind knocked out of him, so there was no injury to him. Running backs in an I formation. Richard Todd up there for the Jets. Dropping back to throw it. Looks to the left side, and he's going long. And Walker is there, and he skids as he tried to turn outside. Incomplete. Wesley Walker, the speedster, the intended receiver.
Richard Todd is now 4 out of 11 in the passing department for 50 yards, the longest to Jerome Barkham for the initial Jets first down. As Lindsey called it, of course, the receiver slipped down in that one. Back to cover was number 28, Rufus Best, the fellow that had the interception just a couple of plays ago in his third year out of South Carolina State. Interesting that the Jets would try to go up top and deep right there, trailing 17-0, get back in the game so quickly, rather than put together some kind of a ball possession drive, because you've had a couple of mistakes already. Another one could be fatal.
Second down, 10 yards to go. And hitting straight in is Kevin Long, the fullback, and Ben Williams is there to hit him immediately. Picked up a yard, maybe two. It'll be a third down play coming up now for the Jets.
Eight carries and just 12 yards for Kevin Long so far in the football game. It's an obvious passing situation now on third down at about 10, as Long just barely got back to the line of scrimmage. Good speed that time by Ben Williams, 77. A big fella, 245, 6'3", but a key element in that Bermuda Triangle defense of the Buffalo Bills.
Harper and Durkin are in the ballgame now for the Jets. Driving back is Todd, penalty marker at the line of scrimmage. Plenty of time, and Todd is throwing into a crowd to Jerome Barkham. It's incomplete. It's intercepted, as a matter of fact. But there is a penalty marker to be checked out. Buffalo Bills pulled it down.
Number 22 in there for the
Steve
Bills.
Steve Freeman
in his seventh year out of Mississippi State. But let's check the flag from the crowd reaction. This is going to be against Buffalo.
Bob McElwee says bring it back. He's the referee.
Bills might have jumped offside in their anticipation of getting to Richard Todd.
Encroachment, number 77, defense lined up in the neutral zone. Third down.
Fred Smirlis, the nose tackle, lined up in the neutral zone. Makes it third down and 5 yards to go. Ball is up there at the 38-yard line now. Kevin Long brings in the next play. He's at the fullback spot. Harper stays in there. Richard Todd waits. Dropping back to look. Todd sets, throws left. And it is caught, but he's hit immediately over there at about the 41-yard line. Harper took it, but it was Villapiano who had him in his grasp immediately.
I think he's way shy of first down yardage. Now Harper comes up quickly to say, wait a minute, where was I? And the Jets will have to punt the football. So obviously New York playing tentatively, making mistakes. They got a break by the fact that the Buffalo Bills lined up offside. Otherwise, it would have been the first interception of the year for Steve Freeman and a change of possession. But now the Bills get the ball back, and if they get any kind of return here by Riddick, we'll have pretty good field position.
Riddick and Pacon drop back, and now Pacon has gone well up toward the line of scrimmage, leaving only Rob Riddick back there. But Pacon's going to rejoin him. He went up there as a messenger, apparently. Now he's going to stay up in tandem, about 30 yards in front.
Jets asked for a measurement, and they're about three-quarters of a yard shy. The crowd wants Walt Michael to go for it, but the crowd always wants the coach to go for it. They don't fire the crowd.
They don't. And he's trailing by 17 points. We're in the first quarter with 3 minutes, 14 seconds left to play in this period. Ramsey's in there to do the punting.
You think it's a little too early in the football game to fake punt?
I think it's a little early. Too early in the game and too late in the season. So Ramsey is back there now waiting for the snap in deep punt formation. Bob McElwee says, okay, we've got it all straightened out. Let's wind it up and go.
All the years you did the Mets here at Shea, did they issue toe warmers?
If they were going to sit down here in this corner, they would have. Ramsey again waiting. Bingham is in to make the snap in deep punt formation. There it is. A little low, but he pulls it up. Gets the kick off. Riddick is near it, but he's going to let it go. There'll be no run back. It's around the 30-yard line. And it's blown dead, so it'll be first and 10 at the 30-yard line, a 28-yard punt by Ramsey.
Lindsay, we've got something new for you here on CBS Radio Network. Beginning next Sunday, January the 3rd, CBS News correspondent Ed Bradley takes you into the Correspondents' Corner. Ed, the newest member of CBS TV's 60 Minutes team, will also be on the radio every Sunday with his thoughtful and very incisive analysis on a top story of the news. Correspondents' Corner with Ed Bradley begins next Sunday, January the 3rd. Hear it here.
All right, here come the Buffalo Bills once again. First and 10 at their own 30-yard line. Running backs in an eye formation. Leaks ahead of Cribbs. Ferguson with the ball. Drops back to setup. Throws it straight up the middle, and it is completed. Taken there by Bramer. Mark Bramer, the tight end from Michigan State. He was hit at the 45-yard line. So that'll be a first and 10 for the Buffalo Bills as immediately they pick up 15 yards to start to move the football. They're leading 17-0. Greg Buddle made the tackle. That's the third first down for the Buffalo Bills.
Bramer, a big target, 6'3", 235. He was the fourth favorite receiver of Ferguson. 33 catches, 365 yards coming in, averaging about 11 yards. That's what you want to do. You clear out the center zone with the wide receivers, let the tight end slide underneath.
Frank Lewis to the right side. Jerry Butler to the left side for Buffalo. Here's Cribb trying to come left. Finds a little daylight and gets up there for about 3 yards to the 48-yard line before Lance Mayall came in to make the tackle.
That's only the second carry of the football game for Joe Cribbs for a total of 6 yards. He, of course, was fifth in the AFC in total rushing. He had over 1,000 yards this year. And the key element in that Buffalo Bills offense, he's also very potent sliding out of the backfield on pass patterns.
1,000-yard gainer for the second consecutive year. Joe Cribbs, he's in the left set now. Roosevelt Leakes is in the right set. Wide receivers left and right for Joe Ferguson. Going to a high count, but he drops back now to take a look. Up the middle, and again, it is complete to Roosevelt Leakes. Roosevelt Leakes got to the 45-yard line of the Jets before he was hit. Blinka made the tackle.
Now, he'll be close to first down yardage. The chain is just shy of the 45-yard line. That's the Jets' 45, and they'll have to ask for a measurement. We've got 1:15 left to go in a 17-point first quarter for the Buffalo Bills. The Jets have yet to score. They have yet to get closer than the 30-yard line of the Buffalo Bills. Ferguson, 5 out of 8 with a very hot hand, a total of 90 yards.
Chain is being brought out now by the head linesman, Leo Miles. McElwee is inspecting, and he says first and 10. So they keep the driver off. Fourth first down for the Buffalo Bills.
And Joe Ferguson doing an excellent job of mixing up the run and the short and the long passes. Just as soon as he kind of lulls the Jet defense to sleep with those 10, 15 yarders, he's been popping to the wide receivers, Lewis and Butler, left and right.
Buffalo Bills move up there with the running backs evened up. Cribbs in the left set. And they move Bramer over in motion. Tight end, outside right. Ferguson with the ball, dropping back. Throws, and it is complete. Taken by Lewis. And he is inside the 30-yard line, struggles to about the 28 before he is hit down. And so the Buffalo Bills have picked up another first and 10.
Defensive back for the New York Jets fell down. Lewis, fourth in the AFC in total catches, ran the corner inside route. Meanwhile, Bramer, who Lindsey said was in motion to the top, turned it outside. And simply because the defensive man fell down, Lewis was wide open.
Lewis, one of the fine pass receivers, will be in the Pro Bowl this year for the first time in his career.
Never understood why the Pittsburgh Steelers let him go.
Well, I think a lot of the Pittsburgh Steelers fans wonder. Now, Roosevelt leaks in motion outside right. And there's a whistle that stops play. A whistle stops play, and there's a penalty marker. Just as they were going to hand it off to Cribbs. So here's one to be checked out by the officials.
Of course, Stallworth and Swan might be two pretty good reasons.
I guess.
Lewis has three catches, 83 yards.
McElwee now is going to explain the penalty.
No foul. No foul. Step or step.
That flag was thrown a long way for there to be no foul.
That's what you call an inadvertent flag.
That one didn't drop. That was thrown.
There was one of those earlier this year at Minnesota. Explained by referee Dick Jorgensen as an inadvertent flag. And it nullified a touchdown. In that case, not here. It's still first down. First and 10 for the Bills at the 28-yard line.
And this should be the final play of the first quarter. Just 9 ticks left on the clock. Very important first quarter for the Bills when you're in the other people's stadium.
Wide receivers left and right. Running backs evened up. Ferguson takes the handoff and drops back. Over the middle, and it's complete to Leakes. Roosevelt Leakes has the first down at the 15-yard line. A big fullback up the middle. Stan Blinken, the middle linebacker, made the tackle. And now time has run out. There's the gun. And that's the end of the first quarter. With the score, Buffalo 17 and the Jets nothing.
For up-to-the-minute weather information, call Nationwide Insurance's Weather Eye, 462-5641. That's 24 hours a day, 462-5641.
This is Paul Newman speaking. I'll bet you're the kind of person people can depend on. Well, that's why I'd like to enlist you as a friend of animals, too. Animals need help. I can't tell you when they need it, but there's an organization that can. It's called Friends of Animals. These concerned people encourage spaying to prevent overpopulation of homeless dogs and cats. Your help is needed. Please contact Friends of Animals at 11 West 60th Street, New York, New York, 10023. Let's all be friends of animals.
Stay with us for the best in sports. Radio 59, WROW, Albany.
Season's greetings, everybody, to you and your family listening across the country to CBS Radio and overseas on American Forces Radio. From yours truly, Jim Kelly, Lindsey Nelson, Jack Buck, Hank Stram. Join us later from Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. The Eagles play host to the New York Giants. Dick Vermeil has the Eagles into the playoffs again. Of course, they were Super Bowl finalists against the Oakland Raiders last year. And Ray Perkins has the New York Giants in the playoffs. The first time the Giants have been in postseason play in 18 years.
So now as we start the second quarter, it's going to be first and 10 for the Buffalo Bills. That ball is spotted at the 16-yard line.
Ferguson, 7 out of 10 in the first quarter, 122 yards, one touchdown. Frank Lewis, 3 catches, 93 of those yards.
Here come the Bills, sending Butler to the left side. Lewis right, running backs in an I formation. Ferguson up there now waiting. Leaks ahead of Cribbs in the I. Ferguson has the ball, dropping back to look. Steps up and spied it out of his hand, incomplete. Is it going to be called a fumble or an incompleted pass? It's overrun by the Jets and recovered by the Bills up on the 48-yard line if it is ruled a fumble. As that ball was being batted around down there.
Mark Gastineau, number 99, tried to scoop it up on the run and go for the touchdown. Instead, he batted, booted, and everything else you could do with a football, and just simply couldn't pick it up. Ferguson back, had the arm cocked, but the ball was stripped loose.
Ken Jones finally fell on it for Buffalo. And it was a fumble, as he never started his arm forward at all. but it is recovered by the Buffalo Bills.
Now that'll be second down, because the New York Jets never had possession of the football, right?
It is second down, and long, long, long. So now the Bills are up there with the ball at their own 48-yard line, but they retain possession. Dropping back now is Ferguson. Runs to the right side and throws back, and it is complete. Taken by Lewis. He's at the 40, 35. Jitterbugging, coming around to the right side of the field, maintains his balance, and gets finally across the 30-yard line. Goes out of bounds just across the 30-yard line. Kirk Springs ran him out.
Crowd is booing, and you can hardly blame them. Frank Lewis, 205 receptions, 3,709 yards coming in. Ferguson had a touchdown. He just did not see Mark Bramer, who was running the deep corner pattern to his right side. Instead, he came back against the grain, found number 82. And then Lewis looked to pick up a block, came back against the grain again, and five, maybe six New York Jets had a shot at him. Lewis was almost like a punt returner, waiting for his blockers, his wall to form, and turn nothing into something. It's still third down and 25. They've got to get it all the way down to the six-yard line of the New York Jets, but Lewis did most of that on his own.
Picked up 22 on that play, but they're still 24, 25 yards short. They're going to the shotgun. Ball is taken by Ferguson. He drops back to look. Goes up the middle again. It's wide open, and the catch is made right there by Cribbs at the 20-yard line, and he goes right down at the 20, and it's still going to be about 13 yards to go for a first down. Lance Mell make the tackle.
But that shows you the calm, cool, collected poise of a Joe Ferguson, 9 years, former Razorback out of Arkansas. Instead of trying to get the first down and maybe the touchdown, going deep on two successive plays, he carefully picked his receivers and just worked the Bills down into field goal range for Nick Mickemeyer.
So Mickemeyer in there now to attempt the field goal. This will be a 37-yarder, Robinson holding for him.
He's 5 out of 7 from this distance.
Ball goes down. Mickemeyer boots it up. It is carrying, and it is a little short underneath the crossbar. Underneath the crossbar, and so the ball goes over at the line of scrimmage.
Well, that's really the first break of the football game for the Jets. The fact that Ferguson was hit as he was back to pass, then the exchange, it took him out of field goal range. Ferguson 9 out of 12, 154 yards and one touchdown. So we've got 12:03 left to go in the first half with the score, Buffalo 17, the Jets nothing. Let's take time out.
Liberals and conservatives rarely agree on anything.
That's not true.
Yes, it is. But when it comes to the Buick Electra, common sense dictates otherwise. It uses fuel conservatively and luxury liberally. Powered by an available fuel-efficient diesel, Electra's 22 EPA estimated MPG is pretty impressive. Use estimated MPG for comparisons. Actual mileage may be different. Buick Electra Park Avenue.
Well, it's got my vote.
No, it doesn't.
It's got mine.
At your Buick dealers today.
Parents, if you have a child who loves football, your kid may be Super Pro material. Any boy or girl can join the NFL Super Pro Club. Members receive great surprises in the mail throughout the year, like team decals, an official Super Pro Club ID, NFL books, a Super Bowl 16 poster, and many other terrific things. Worth much more than a $6 membership fee. For your child's application, write NFL Super Pro Club, Box 9000, Trenton, New Jersey, 08650. Do it today.
Word from the sideline that Mark Gastineau, number 99, partially deflected that 37-yard field goal try by Nick Mickemeyer. It was just about 2 yards shy, whatever. He got enough to make it no good. And the Bills still lead it 17-0.
Here come the Jets, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Richard Todd, the quarterback. The running backs are evened up. They're in a slot right. Richard Todd dropping back. Now moves up, keeps the football, and finally throws to Durking. Scott Durking hit immediately up there on the 26, 27-yard line. Filippiano on the tackle. Make it second down and 3 at the 27 for the New York Jets.
Richard Todd, Lindsey, came very close to stepping over the line of scrimmage on that play. I thought for a moment he had. Richard is 6 out of 13, 60 yards on the afternoon. The tackle made by Filippiano, a three-time Pro Bowler. There are 7 members of the AFC Pro Bowl squad in this football game. For the Jets, Marvin Powell, center Joe Fields, Mark Gastineau, and Joe Klecko. For the Buffalo Bills, Frank Lewis, Joe Cribbs, and tackle Fred Smirlis.
Gaffney's in the wide right now as Richard Todd. Again, as his running backs evened up, he drops the snap. Falls forward to scramble for the football. I think he got it. Richard Todd dropped the snap and fell forward to pull it in just at the line of scrimmage.
The Jets have had one fumble. They've had one interception. They had another interception nullified by a Buffalo penalty. And now a fumble that Richard Todd pulled back in. So it's third and three, inside 11 minutes left to go in the first half, and the Jets have yet to threaten to score.
Jets back in their huddle. Still calling the next play. Wesley Walker comes out of the huddle to take a wide right. Running backs are evened up. Scott Durking is in there. Now Todd drops back, takes a look. Penalty marker. He's sacked. Ken Johnson got to him, but there is a penalty marker to be checked out. So Bob McAlee, the referee, is checking with the headlinesman who threw the flag. Offsides is indicated against Buffalo, which will nullify the sack. That will be enough for the first down for the Jets.
The Bills have been penalized three times for 15 yards. That's really the second time the penalties have hurt the Buffalo Bills, once on the interception that was negated, and now the sack.
Number 27, defense, lined up in the neutral zone. First down.
Intermittently, but we are told that, again, the Buffalo Bills lined up in the neutral zone. That's the second time. That's exactly what happened on the pass interception that was negated. Buffalo leads the NFL in yards penalized with 1,001 yards. Then the Bears, the Lions, and the Chargers.
First and 10 at the 32-yard line. Gaffney's in the wide right. Now play action, and Todd is throwing to Gaffney, and he's up at the 50-yard line. Gaffney is at the 48, and he's pinned right there by Jim Haslett, linebacker for the Buffalo Bills. That'll be a first and 10. Pickup of 19 yards.
Derek Gaffney, number 81, in his fourth year out of Florida. Excellent speed. And Gaffney in the receiving department coming in was way down. He didn't get that much playing time, of course, playing behind Lamb Jones. 14 catches, 250 yards.
Fourth first out of the ballgame for the New York Jets. Kevin Long is barred in the next play. They simply send this one into the line with Long carrying, and he got relatively nothing on the play. Ran into a whole gang of people right in the middle, led by Irvin Parker, so it is second and 10 at the 48-yard line.
Four carries, 13 yards for Kevin Long so far this afternoon. Must be a heck of a feeling when you run in with the play, you're the ball carrier, and it goes nowhere.
And he comes right back out as Tom Newton is coming in with the next play now.
Say, wait a minute, give me another play here.
Jets again back in their huddle, and here they come. They're sending Wesley Walker out to a wide right, and they're doubling him out there with Derek Gaffney. Shuler's in a wide left, dropping back is Todd, throws up the middle. Gaffney again, reaches up to get it at the 37-yard line. Pulls it in and goes right down there at the 37. Charles Rome's on the tackle. First and 10 for the Jets.
Suddenly the Jets offensive line starting to keep Buffalo out of there. Give Richard Todd some time to throw the ball. Joe Fields, the center. Dan Alexander at the right guard. Randy Rasmussen, number 66, the left guard, the only member of the New York Jets with any playoff experience. He, of course, was on the Super Bowl team back in 1969, led by Joe Namath and company.
First and 10 now for the Jets, the ball at the 37-yard line. Move the running backs over. Harper's in there. Dropping back is Todd. Again up the middle. Intercepted this time. And it's at the 24-yard line. And being returned by Filippiano over across the 40-yard line. And he's out of bounds. And the Buffalo Bills again get possession on Phil Villapiano's interception. The veteran linebacker headed right at the belt buckle and advanced it up to the 40-yard line, first and 10.
We told you Villapiano was a pro bowler from years gone by. That time Todd had his man, but Villapiano stepped right in front of the intended receiver, went to the sideline on the left side, got a lead block by Mario Clark, number 29, and that's the third turnover against the New York Jets. Two interceptions, one fumble, 17-0, 8:14 to go in the first half. We'll be back in just a moment.
Show on your way home this afternoon.
sports lovers turn us on. I'm Win Elliott of CBS Radio Sports, and each weekday morning is Sports World Roundup, where Jim Kelly and I alternate with the latest sports news from overnight.
I'm Brent Musburger, and each weekday evening with my edition of Sports Time.
I'm Bill Schweitzer. Weekends, I kick off the sports coverage with my Sports Time reports.
Then I come back with my 12 Sports Central USA broadcasts each weekend.
And I'm Len Berman with three late-night editions of Sports Central every Saturday night.
And I'm Howard David with my three late-night editions of Sports Central every Sunday.
And with all this, we got a lot more, too. NFL Monday Night Football with Jack Buck and Hank Stram. Live coverage of big events and horse racing, tennis, golf, and college bowl games. So you can tell sports is important to us. And that's why sports lovers turn us on all week long on most of these CBS radio network stations. Sports, hear it here.
On this Buffalo Bill team, there are six Buffalo players with 10 years experience or more. Phil Villapiano with 11 years out of Bowling Green. Isaiah Robertson is 11th year out of Southern. Ron Jesse is 11th year out of Kansas. And Frank Lewis is 11th out of Grambling. You can see the key, the nucleus, the veterans who've been around before in the playoffs. Villapiano, former Raider, and they're all responding with big effort here against the Jets.
Buffalo first and 10 at the 40. Ferguson with the ball now. Sets to throw and completes it to his fullback. Roosevelt leaks up at the 45-yard line. Let's pause 5 seconds for stations to identify themselves on the CBS Radio Network.
Stay with us for the best in sports. Radio 59, WROW, Albany.
Roosevelt Leaks, not known for a wide receiver. He's used primarily on short yardage situations, but Ferguson going to the safety valve there. Leaks had 7 catches over the course of 16 games, but he's got 3 catches so far here this afternoon.
Second down and 5 yards to go. Butler to the right side, Lewis to the left side. This time they leave it on the ground. Cribbs tries the left side, but he's cut off and cuts back. Gets across the 45 to maybe the 46-yard line and is hit immediately. Gastineau made the tackle. So it'll be third down and about 4 yards to go.
That's only the third carry in the football game for Joe Cribbs, a total of just 7 yards. So you can see that Ferguson has had the hot hand. He's 10 out of 13, 156 yards and 1 touchdown in the passing department. Faced with 3rd and 4 now, the Bills will undoubtedly go to the shotgun formation. Leaks checks out along with number 86, the big tight end, Mark Bramer.
Ron Jesse comes in, so does Roland Hicks. Roland Hooks, I beg your pardon. Shotgun formation for Ferguson. Waiting now for the snap, and he's got it. Drops back to take a look. Plenty of time, and he throws it complete. Taken by Krebs at the 30-yard line. And he gets all the way down to the 25-yard line. Joe Cribbs made the reception. It is a first and 10 Buffalo at the 25-yard line, a 29-yard pickup.
Getting up very slowly is Ken Jones, the 6-year tackle out of Arkansas State. He was facing that sack exchange. Mark Gastineau, Joe Klecko and company coming in. And Jones is holding the back of his right leg. Is walking very, very slowly back to the Buffalo Bill huddle. You've not heard the name Conrad Dobler so far this afternoon. He has been in and out of Chuck Knox's doghouse all season long. And Dobler responded vocally to a penalty against him in that Miami Dolphin game, wishing ill will toward one of the NFL officials, and has not been playing in this football game.
First and 10 at the 25-yard line. Roosevelt Leaks, the big fullback, powers through the 21-yard line. Picked up 4 on the play. It'll be 2nd down and 6 yards to go. Klecko in to make the tackle for the Jets. Clock is running with 5 minutes, 43 seconds remaining to be played in the first half. And an injury delay here for the moment. Bob McAwee indicates he's going to hold up play and not mark the ball until Leaks is up. But he is up, and now it's marked ready for play.
Dobler, Lindsey, was called, as you recall, in the game we did last week in the Orange Bowl against the Dolphins for a key holding call as the Bills were trying to sustain some kind of a drive in that 16-6 loss. And the day after in the Miami papers was quoted as saying, look, that official's trying to take money out of my pocket and food off my family's table. He had some rather unkind things to say about the officiating crew. And I think Chuck Knox responded with a severe benching.
Dobler has just come into the ballgame. Borchardt has gone out. Here's a penalty marker. Throw to Roosevelt. Leaks in the right flat. He goes out of bounds at the 14-yard line. Roosevelt Leaks was hit by Buttle and went out of bounds at the 16. At the 14, there's a penalty marker to be checked out.
Tom Lynch, number 61, his fifth year out of Boston College, was talking to the referee right away, so you'd guess, and the crowd has responded, it is, in fact, against the Buffalo Bills.
A procedure penalty against the Buffalo Bills?
Well, if they follow form, they probably lined up offsides. That's what the defense has done twice.
McElwee says, give me the football, and then he's going to spot it and mark off the penalty of 5 yards against the Buffalo Bills, and he'll tell us about it.
Illegal formation, offense, number 70, not up on the line of scrimmage. Second down.
Joe Devlin was not up on the line of scrimmage.
And Ferguson just said something into the huddle. He acknowledged.
Second and 11.
This is a big series defensively, I think, for the New York Jets. They're trailing 17-0. If the Bills score a touchdown here before halftime, they're going to go in a very disgruntled bunch.
Second and 11 at the 26-yard line. Ferguson dropping back. Buster Barnett's in the ball game, and Lewis in the end zone. Touchdown! Frank Lewis took it right at the goal line. It was into the end zone for the touchdown. The Buffalo has six more on the board.
Ferguson never saw it. Marty Lyons had thrown him down his third year out of Alabama, former Crimson Tide. But Ferguson heard the crowd respond with that huge groan, and Lewis comes up with his second key grab of the evening, or the afternoon. Ferguson simply a post pattern that time, and Joe threw it right on the money. Looked for a moment like it might be a little bit high, but on the deep post pattern, Lewis has put Buffalo out in front 26-0. McNamara will attempt to make it 27-0.
He dragged Bobby Jackson into the end zone. Jackson was holding on to the jersey. McNamara now to attempt the conversion.
I think it's safe to say about the only thing the Jets have held on to all afternoon has been the jersey.
Just about. The ball is down. McNamara boots it up, and it's good. So the conversion is good. Somebody sailed a paper plate or something similar out onto the field just at the point of impact there. But it is good, and so with the score. Buffalo 24 and the Jets nothing. Let's take timeout.
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Jim Kelly, Lindsey Nelson back at a very quiet and subdued Shea Stadium right now. The locals are shell-shocked because they have watched their Jets into the playoffs for the first time in 12 years fall behind by a whopping score of 24-0 over the first 25 minutes of this football game. They have been totally inept on offense. They have committed three turnovers, a fumble on the initial kickoff, and since then, two interceptions.
McNamara with the kickoff now. The ball is up. It's going to be comparatively short, and it's heading over toward the sideline and goes out of bounds. So the flag is thrown. They'll take it back. 5-yard penalty and boot it all over again. Kurt Sohn was watching very carefully, but
against
made no effort to field the ball.
Re-kick with a 5-yard penalty.
Re-kick it with a 5-yard penalty, says referee Bob McElwee, and so they take it back upfield. 4 minutes, 56 seconds on the clock. That's time remaining to be played in the first half, with the Buffalo Bills leading by a score of 24-0. And next Sunday, the winner of this game plays the Cincinnati Bengals. Of course, on Saturday, it's going to be San Diego against Miami in the playoffs in the American Football Conference.
And we'll be at both of them.
We'll be at both of them is right. At halftime today, Brent Musburger talks with New York Giants head coach Ray Perkins for a look ahead to the important game in Philadelphia today. Again, the kickoff now. Coming over to Sun's side of the field. He's got it at the 20, to the 25, to the 30, to the 35, to the 40, to the 45, and he has run out of bounds. Kurt Sohn with the kickoff return, and a good one finally run out by Curtis Brown of the Buffalo Bills. So they will start it now, first down at 10 yards to go.
at the 47-yard line.
Did Brent have to pay for that interview? Perkins doesn't talk a whole lot.
He really doesn't. Words are one syllable.
That game, of course, coming up at 3:15 Eastern time over many of these same CBS Radio Network stations. Jack Buck, Hank Stram, Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia, the Eagles and the New York Giants.
Walker and Gaffney in a wide right. Ball is handed off instead to Freeman McNeil. He tries to cut, slips a little bit in the muddy midfield and dives up at the 50-yard line for three. Second and seven at the 50-yard line.
We had mentioned that the Jets were low and the entire NFL is allowing points in the first quarter, 37, but it was 17-0 Buffalo after the first quarter of play. You look as far as the Jets scoring in the second half has been, they've been about dead even with their opponents in the second stanza, but not against a defense as tough as the Buffalo Bills.
Kevin Long is brought in the next play. He's in there as the fullback. Running backs are tightened up a little bit now. Freeman McNeil is the running back in there with Long. And Freeman McNeil gets the handoff and moves in there to about the 46-yard line. For 4 yards, it'll be third down and about three. Jet fans are unhappy at the slow progress being made on the ground here by a team trailing by 24 points.
Under 4 minutes left in the first half. Of course, the team that is trailing by 24 points has already committed three costly turnovers, a fumble and two interceptions. They dearly would like to put some points up on the scoreboard here before the end of the first half. Some would think it would be a must. The Jets are 2 out of 6 on third down conversions.
Harper and Dierking are in there now. Two fine receivers in there to running backs, indicating they're going to go to the air, and they are. Todd dropping back. Throws to Dierking. He's got it at the 40-yard line to the 35. Scott Dierking down to the 30-yard line. First and 10 for the New York Jets. On the tackle, Rufus Betts. Six first down of the ballgame for the Jets.
And Rufus, who has an interception so far this afternoon, getting up very slowly. Also getting up slowly, Charles Roams. Now, Roams is the one who started this route in progress on the opening kickoff when Bruce Harper fumbled. Charles scooped it up and went 26 unanswered yards for a 7-0 Buffalo lead. That time, Scott Dierking just waited for the wide receivers to clear things out. 5-year former Boilermaker out of Purdue. And throwing underneath was Richard Todd, who is now 9 out of 17, 108 yards.
An injury delay here for Rome, who was winded early on the ballgame and came out. He's getting attention from the training staff of the Buffalo Bills. And when play is resumed, the Jets will have it first and 10 at the 30-yard line of the Buffalo Bills.
We mentioned at the top of the broadcast that the Buffalo Bills lead this series between two of the original teams in the old American Football League by a margin of 24 wins to 20 losses. This is, of course, the third time these two teams have met this year. 31-0, the Bills win in Buffalo. And then the Jets came back to even it up with a 21-point third quarter to win 33-14 here at Shea Stadium. This was to be a matchup between the defensive line of the New York Jets and the offensive line of the Buffalo Bills. Well, so far, that has been won by the Buffalo Bills. Ferguson with a hot hand early in the football game, aided, of course, by that very strange word, momentum, which took effect on that opening fumble by the Jets, and the Bills never had to look back. They led 7-0, then 14-0, 17-0 after the first quarter, and Lewis, with his second touchdown grab, increased the Bills' advantage to 24-0. And the Jets, Lindsey, have to get some points on the scoreboard here. You can't go in a playoff game, the first time you've been in a playoff for many of your young players now, trailing 24-0 at halftime against a veteran team like the Buffalo Bills.
All right, here they come. First and 10. They have the ball at the Buffalo 30-yard line. The running backs are split now. That's Harper in there with Kevin Long. I beg your pardon. It's Newton in there with Kevin Long. And dropping back now is Todd. Pumps once and throws long. And down to the end zone. Touchdown. It's taken by Mickey Schuler in the end zone. The Jet fans now finally have something to yell about for the first time this afternoon. As it was pulled in by Mickey Schuler in the end zone.
Mickey Schuler, number 82, the backup tight end to Jerome Barkham and others, 6'3", 235, former Nittany Lion out of Penn State. Check this out. Did not catch a pass all this year. He picked the right time to get his first one.
Pat Leahy is in the boot now. Pat Ryan is in the hole farm. The ball is down. Leahy boots it up, and it's good. So the Jets have the touchdown and the conversion. It came with 2 minutes 47 seconds remaining to be played in the first half. And it is now the Buffalo Bills 24 and the New York Jets 7 on the scoreboard.
city streets and country roads.
International.
Making deliveries, hauling loads.
International.
Whatever job you've got to do, the number one name in trucks means saving for you.
International.
Whatever your trucking needs are, International's out to lower your cost of ownership. Right now, you can save thousands of dollars with special year-end price allowances at participating International dealers. And if you do buy before the end of your 1981 tax year, you may also gain a whole year's worth of tax benefits. Ask your International dealer soon just how much you can save. There's never been a better time to buy at International.
Whatever job's got to be done, International can cost you less to run. We're the number one name in trucks, International.
International.
Mickey Schuler, his first catch of the year. He did it for a touchdown. The Jets are on the board. He beat Steve Freeman, the seven-year veteran out of Mississippi State. The Bills have 2:45 with which to work in the first half.
Here's the kickoff. Curtis Brown at the three-yard line. He's to the five. Can he make the midfield 15, 20? Across the 25, and he's struggling toward the 30-yard line. Curtis Brown on the kickoff as Buffalo has possession now. 2:35 on the clock as we approach the two-minute warning.
And Ferguson, who has only missed on three passes, 12 of 15, 211 yards, and two touchdowns, will try to get the Bills into good field position, either for a field goal try by Mickomar or maybe another touchdown. Buffalo has all three timeouts remaining.
Bobby Jackson is being assisted off the field. Jet cornerback, co-captain on the defense. First and 10 at the 29-yard line, now for Buffalo. Ferguson up there. Running backs are well split. Ferguson dropping back. Takes a look. Goes up the middle. Incomplete. Kramer, the tight end, the man for whom it was intended. Buffalo Bills have discovered that their wide receivers are being doubled and that the fertile ground is up the middle. That's where they've been completing them that time. Kramer could not hold on, so it's second and 10 at the 29-yard line.
Ken Troy, number 48, the strong side safety, 6'2", in his fifth year out of Maryland, back there on the coverage. Started all 16 games for the Jets this year, sixth on the team with tackles, and second on the squad with eight passes defensed against. Had two interceptions, one against the Patriots, one against the Colts.
Butler wide left, Frank Lewis wide right. Tight end Bramer right, running backs in an I formation. And it's taken by Krebs off the tailback. He tries the right side. Gets only to the 30 for a gain of only a yard before Gastineau brought him down. So it'll be third down. And 9 yards to go at the 30-yard line.
Fourth carry of the football game for Joe Cribbs, only 7 yards in the first half. What a surprise that is. But when you're passing as effectively as Joe Ferguson has been, you go with them that brung you. Mark Gastineau, number 99, in there on the tackle, a Pro Bowler this year. You'll hear the Pro Bowl here on CBS Radio. You heard the crowd come to life. Gastineau, after the sack, got up and started waving his arms, trying to incite this crowd to bring them to life. They haven't had much to cheer about here in the first half. We're at the two-minute warning. The Bills lead it 24-7. We'll be back in a moment.
Hi, I'm Lennon Saunders. This is Heartbeat. Are you depressed? Is it hard to get out of bed in the morning? Do you look forward to, well, nothing? Perhaps some chain of events, something you couldn't control, has affected your life. Maybe you've lost your job or experienced the death of a family member or a friend. Whatever the cause, you're depressed. You're not able to shake the feeling of gloom that hangs over your head. Well, I've got news for you, and it's good news. There's a way to handle your depression. And here's one idea. Decide that you have the ability to decide what your life is going to be like and how you're going to feel about life. To get more suggestions on how to handle depression, just put the word depression on a postcard or in a letter and send it to me at this address. Heartbeat, Hartford, Connecticut, 06142. Ask for the depression plan. It's free. The address, Heartbeat, Hartford, Connecticut, 06142. This is Heartbeat.
They haven't had that many key plays for both the offense and the defense so far in the first half. This is one, however. It's 3rd and 9 for the Buffalo Bills. 2 minutes left to go in the first half. They're leading by 17 points. The momentum might be switching just a little bit after the touchdown catch and after Gastineau's sack of Joe Kripp. Now, if you're the Buffalo Bills, you want to pick up the first down yardage, obviously. Keep the ball and the drive alive. Keep the ball away from the New York Jets. The Jets will be coming. They would probably blitz. Try to put some pressure on Ferguson, who will operate out of the shotgun, force him into a mistake, or at the very least, rushing his pass so it goes incomplete, and the Jets get the ball back and try to get down for a field goal at the very least, maybe a touchdown to get back into this football game.
We're having a little trouble with the clock here, and that's the reason for the delay. Bob McAlee's gone over to Fritz Graff, the field judge now, and is talking to him about the situation, and we're running time down on the clock once again to get it corrected before we start the final 2 minutes.
It froze.
It apparently did. So it is being run down now. It is down to 2:55 and running. So as soon as the clock is set, McAlee will mark the ball ready for play. He reports over now to the sideline, to the Jets sideline, that whatever it was they complained about the clock is being corrected.
Some of the Jet fans down in the end zone have taken to remove some of their clothing, notably their jacket and their shirt. And their undershirt.
They are flying on high octane.
They're not on low lead, are they?
Clock is still being run down, so we are being delayed for that reason. It'll be 3rd down and 9 yards to go. The ball is at the 30-yard line for the Buffalo Bills in their territory.
Lindsey, we've got terrific postseason college football for you right here on New Year's Day with the Cotton Bowl game, the Longhorns of Texas taking on the Crimson Tide of Alabama. CBS Radio Sports will be on the scene all day. It's Jack Buck and Roman Gabriel, the Cotton Bowl. Friday, New Year's Day, CBS Radio Sports.
And now the Buffalo Bills are up there in a shotgun, waiting for the direct snap. There's Joe Ferguson. He has the ball, dropping back and throwing over to the left side, and he overthrows Lewis, incomplete. That'll bring up a 4th down, and the hand is for the defense of the Jets. And the punting unit is coming on now for Buffalo.
Kind of an interesting play call. Lindsey has correctly pointed out that the Bills' strength has been the short pass over the middle, those little 8 to 10 to 12-yard passes that have been kind of picking away at the New York Jets. He lulls them to sleep. Then he's been hitting Lewis on the deep post pattern for the score. That time he runs a corner out pattern, throws it a little bit wide, and the Jets have an excellent opportunity and good field position after this punt.
Greg Cater is in to do the punting now. Harper's dropped back, standing at his own 30-yard line for the Jets to receive it. Cater gets it off. Harper moves over. Fair catch signal goes up. He moves up and makes the catch just short of the 35-yard line. So that is where the Jets will start. A 35-yard punt with no return on the fair catch.
Let's check the stats now on Richard Todd. He is 10 out of 18. At one time, he was almost a disaster area. He was 4 out of 11 with 2 interceptions, but Richard got it together. He has brought the Jets back. 10 out of 18, 138 yards, and 1 touchdown. The last, a scoring strike to Mickey Schuler. And now the Jets from the 35 will try to work it down into Bill's scoring territory. As we're in the landing pattern here over LaGuardia.
Clock shows 2:02 now, and it was finally reset. It was set at 2:15, and it is down to 2:02 as the Jets have the ball, and Todd drops back to take a look. Steps up now. Here's the line of scrimmage. Drops back. Throws again near the sideline. Incomplete. Intended for Schuler. Mickey Schuler, who scored the touchdown a moment ago, the man for whom the pass was intended.
Richard must have radar. He approached the line of scrimmage again. It's the 35-yard line, as if he were going to run with the ball, then drew it back, retreated another 3 yards, looked for Schuler on the crossing pattern, and now we are under 2 minutes.
So apparently we have reached the second two-minute warning. The other was apparently a call timeout, and the clock was run down to 2 at that time, which we set at 2:15. And now it's at 1:54, and we have another timeout, and members of the training staffs are out there with their teams on the field.
Don't forget, at halftime today, Brent Musburger talks with the New York Giants head coach, Ray Perkins, for a look ahead to the important game between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Giants. That'll be coming up at halftime here on CBS, and then Jack Buck and Hank Stram, probably at Veterans Stadium even as we speak, getting ready for the broadcast here on CBS Radio. The Eagles in the Super Bowl last year against the Oakland Raiders came up on the short end. They did not win the division this year. The Dallas Cowboys reclaimed what has been theirs for so many, many years. Talking to a good friend of yours, works down in Texas, Frank Lieber, the other day. We were speculating as just how long Tom Landry might be the head coach in Dallas, and Frank said another 3 to 5 years. We're trying to figure out where Tom will wind up on the all-time coaching list. He's third right now, closing in on Curly Lambeau and George Halas.
Well, you can speculate all you want, but he's never going to leave. Tom Landry's always going to be the head coach of the Cowboys.
It's 22 years there, right?
Right. Dropping back now is Todd as play is resumed, and the pass is almost intercepted at the 40-yard line. Rufus Best had it on his fingertips, could not hang on the Jet 40-yard line. Incomplete.
And back on the Jet 24-yard line, an ailing Richard Todd clinging to that left knee. He was sacked, and I believe the man that got through was Smirlis, number 76. That time they had the blitz on. It came right up the middle. Todd released the ball and was thrown down and came down. Actually, it looked like he came down on the right knee, but it was the left knee that got tangled up, and he is being attended to down at the 24-yard line.
I think it was Ben Williams. Lending assistance there. So Pat Ryan is loosening up his arm along the sideline now, as attention is still being given to the Jet quarterback. And now timeout is indicated by the referee as Todd gets up, is walking around, tentatively trying out the knee, and indicates he's all right and he wants to stay in the ball game, and he will. Richard Todd stays in.
The last time the New York Jets were in a playoff game of any consequence, they were led by a quarterback with a couple of bad knees. Joe Willie Namath. He led them all the way to the Super Bowl.
And guaranteed it.
Unlike Jimmy the Greek.
It'll be third down and 10 yards to go with the ball at the 35-yard line. The clock says 1:49. It will start on the snap.
The Greek liked Baltimore, as I recall, in that game, didn't he?
I think so.
Liked him big, didn't he?
Lots of people like Baltimore, as a matter of fact.
The Jets are out of timeouts. The Bills have all three with which to work.
Here come the Jets now, sending Walker out to a wide right. Split the running backs. Harper's in there now. Richard Todd waiting for the snap. Dropping back to take a look. And throws to Walker incomplete, trying to cut over toward the middle. So it'll be fourth down coming up for the Jets, and the punting unit is coming on. 1:45 on the clock.
Bill Simpson, number 45, the free safety, a veteran out of Michigan State, back there on the coverage. And he might have had a shot at the interception. Instead, he played the receiver and wanted to make sure that he made the tackle or at the very least jarred the ball loose.
Chuck Ramsey's coming to do the punting. Lou Facone has dropped back. Rob Riddick is back there with him to receive it for Buffalo.
You know, the Bills aren't out of this offensively either. They've got 1:45 and all three timeouts left. If Riddick gets a good return, they'll have good field position.
Bingham is in to make the snap in deep punt formation to Chuck Ramsey. Receivers are about their own 25-yard line for the Buffalo Bills. Ramsey gets the ball, puts it up. Riddick and Pacone let it hit. There'll be no run back, and it's going to be downed at the 30-yard line. Still rolling for the moment. We thought it had been killed at the 30. Apparently it hadn't. So it'll be spotted, and now the Buffalo Bills will have it with 1:32 on the clock. 38-yard punt. And it's going to be spotted at the 32-yard line.
Slippery little football there. They marked it a couple times.
We've had a misting rain here. We had it in New York this morning, and at the start of the ball game, we had a misting rain. It stopped and started again. So it's been that kind of a day.
It has not really been typical Shea Stadium weather, however. Usually the wind is swirling much more than this, and it plays havoc with the passing game.
Exactly. All right, here come the Buffalo Bills out into their shotgun. Joe Ferguson ready to get the direct snap. They have it at their own 32-yard line. He drops back, takes a look, throws, and it is incomplete. Cribbs had it in and out of his hands, incomplete, in danger territory because he was up there a long time.
Ferguson now 12 out of 18, and the reason that Lindsey said it was danger territory, the ball was in the grasp of Joe Cribbs, and then there were a couple of linebackers for the Jets in the vicinity. Ron Crosby, number 55, a four-year man out of Penn State. He had a shot at the ball, but had his head turned the wrong way. 1:27. Clock, of course, is stopped on the incompleted pass.
Second and 10 at the 32-yard line for the Buffalo Bills, who are leading in this ballgame by a score of 24-7 as we approach the halftime intermission. A wild card playoff game here at Shea Stadium in New York. Buffalo once again into the shotgun. Ferguson gets the direct snap, backpedals and looks up the middle, and it is intercepted by the Jets at the 41-yard line and being returned by Greg Buddle. Buddle across the 20-yard line and out of bounds. The Jets get the ball inside the 20 on Buddle's interception. It's going to be first and 10. The crowd is alive now at Shea Stadium.
And what a quick turn of events. Buddle stepped in front of it. Ferguson got a little careless that time. He's had things soft the entire first half, throwing over the middle. He went to the well one too many times, and that time Buddle was ready and waiting. They had the nickel back defense in there. They're playing a zone defense, and that time Ferguson trying to hit the back, looping out of the backfield, just fired over the head of the intended receiver. Buddle jumped up in front of it, big number 51 did, the six-year veteran out of Penn State. Second interception on the year for the former Nittany Lion, and once again, the Jets have good field position.
First and 10 at the 14-yard line. Raymond McNeil's in the tailback now in the I formation. Richard Todd's waiting for the snap. Quick pitch to McNeil. Tries right tackle, but he's hit immediately as he got to the line of scrimmage. Raymond McNeil, the number one draft choice out of UCLA. No gain on the play.
Lindsey, did it look to you at all like McNeil might have been on the halfback option, like he had intended to pass the ball? He saw the receiver cover, then tucked it under?
Looked that way when he started. It certainly did. They're up there ready to go once again now.
Jets are out of timeouts, remember.
Newton steps up to say a word to the quarterback. Todd, short drop, throw, sideline, pattern complete. Taken by Walker over just near the sideline. Inside the 10-yard line. Went out of bounds immediately just inside the 10.
That was a mistake by the Buffalo Bills defense. They were intending that Richard Todd would simply throw the ball out of bounds. They were playing very, very soft, and he got good yardage on the play.
It'll be third down, about 4 yards to go. So the Jets now reconvene their huddle. The clock stopped, of course, as the receiver went out of bounds, and we have 47 seconds left until the halftime intermission. Durkin splits out to the right side now. Harper's the other running back. Dropping back is Todd. Goes to the right corner. Incomplete. Intended for Shuler, who caught the touchdown pass a moment ago. It'll be fourth and four now at the 9-yard line. And here comes the field goal unit on there as the Jets want to try to get three more points before the halftime intermission.
Rufus Best with one interception. Good man-on-man coverage that time against Mickey Shuler in his third year out of South Carolina State, Rufus Best is. He's only 5'9". That's awfully small for a cornerback. Good speed, the good hands. And he came up with a key play there. So Leahy in to try a chip shot field goal.
26 yards with Ryan holding. It's down, it's up, and it's good. So the Giants, the Jets get three more points before the halftime intermission. That one coming with 43 seconds showing on the clock. And we have a 24-10 ball game now. So having seen the Buffalo Bills take the early big lead, the Jets have been fighting back, and they have managed 10 points before the halftime intermission.
It was 24-0 when Lewis pulled in his second touchdown toss of the afternoon, 26 yards from Ferguson. That followed an interception by Phil Villapiano, and that was with 5:02 left to play in the first half. But with 2:47, Todd, a 25-yard scoring strike to Mickey Shuler. That made it 24-7, and then a 26-yard field goal. That's 24-10, and the Jets are back in it. That old momentum switching once again.
CBS Radio Sports will bring you the NFL divisional playoff action next weekend. Saturday, it's Tampa Bay at Dallas, beginning at 12:45 p.m. Eastern time. Then we'll have San Diego at Miami at 4:45 p.m. Eastern time. Sunday, the winner of today's game will go up against Cincinnati at 12:45 p.m. Eastern time. And finally, San Francisco will be challenged by the NFC wildcard team at 4:45 p.m. Eastern time. Don't miss the NFL divisional playoffs next weekend. Hear them here.
Isn't it nice not to have to explain all the playoff possibilities?
It's nice not to try to have understand them yourself, really. Ball is being teed up on the 35-yard line. Riddick and Brown have dropped back to receive it for Buffalo. Clock starts when it's touched by a member of the receiving team in the field of play since we're in the last 2 minutes of the half. Leahy's kick.
Rob Riddick is retreating, and he takes it 2 yards deep in the end zone, runs it out, goal line five, to the 10, to the 15, and hits the deck, skidding as he got across the 15-yard line. So that is where Buffalo will start it now.
Curtis Brown was the up back, five-year Missouri veteran, and he was trying to signal to Riddick to stay in the end zone. Riddick took 2.5 steps forward, and by that time was across the goal line, so Riddick had to run it out. And I'm sure, speaking of running it out, that the Bills at this point will run out the clock. They've made one mistake, the interception, which led to that Leahy field goal. And all of a sudden, a 24-0 advantage has been chopped to two touchdowns, 24-10.
First and 10 at the 17-yard line now, as the Buffalo Bills slowly come out of the huddle. They will try to kill the clock if they have the safety man out there to pick up fumbles. And it's taken by Ferguson, and he simply hits the deck. And the clock is running, and the Jets are out of times out, so they can't stop it. Clock continues to run.
The Bills are in their prevent offense.
They are. Ball is marked ready for play, but it's 24 seconds, and they don't really have to come out of this huddle. They don't have to snap it at all, because it's 19 seconds, 18 seconds, 21 seconds still on the 30-second clock, so they don't have to snap it. And they are heading for the sideline with all intents and purposes. This first half come to a close with the clock still running down to 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and that is that. There's the gun sounding the end of the first half with the score. Buffalo Bills 24 and the New York Jets 10.
United Van Lines presents Stiller and Mira.
Myrna, you're not holding up your end.
Howard, the couch is heavy.
One more flight of stairs. We got it made.
There's an easier way to move. Call United Van Lines.
We save money by moving ourselves. Trust me.
Last time I trusted you, we had twins. Call United.
What's wrong with the truck I rented?
It smells funny inside. United Vans are sanitized treated.
Myrna, the couch.
United Van Lines are the quality movers.
Okay, Myrna, drop it.
Now?
Now. Myrna!
And United takes the pain out of moving.
United Van Lines. We're in the yellow pages.
I'm Marvin Powell of the New York Jets, and out there is the Big Apple, that megalopolis called Greater New York. And do you know what's at the core of the Big Apple? It's people, more than 9 million of them, in every direction. They're the heart of what makes this the greatest city in the world, because no matter where you work or live, there's a United Way in your community working for you. United Way supports the Foundation for Children with Learning Disabilities in small agencies for children whose diseases don't have a telethon named after them. Your United Way support helps them and so many more. The aged, the handicapped, sick and needy. Through your help and the special contribution of the National Football League and its NFL charities, we're able to say, thanks to you, it works for all of us.
Thanks to you, it works for all of us. You and your United Way.
The preceding message on behalf of the United Way, furnished by the National Football League. Jim Kelly, Lindsey Nelson back at a sold-out Shea Stadium here in New York City. The Jets in the playoffs for the first time in 12 years playing host to the Buffalo Bills. The Bills a wild card entrant after winning the AFC East a year ago. We're at halftime. Buffalo leads it 24-10. The Bills had a 24-0 lead, but the last two scores put on the board by the New York Jets. Bills scored very quickly. The Jets won the toss. They elected to receive. That might have been their first mistake because Bruce Harper hit with the ball, fumbled at about the 24-yard line. The Buffalo Bills' Charles Rome scooped it up and went 26 unanswered yards for the score. The point after by Nick Mickemeyer was good. And before many of the fans had settled back into their seats here at Shea, the opposition, the Buffalo Bills, had a 7-0 lead. That became 14-0 with 7:57 left to go in the first quarter. Joe Ferguson, his 25th scoring strike of the season, connecting with Frank Lewis from 50 yards out. Point after by Mickemeyer was good, and it was 14-0 Buffalo. It became 17-0 in favor of the Bills following a Rufus Vest interception, his first of the year, a 48-yard return. That set up a 29-yard field goal by Mickemeyer, and the first quarter ended 17-0 in favor of Buffalo over the Jets. Buffalo again came up with a turnover. Phil Villapiano, his first interception of the year, 5:02 to play in the first half. Joe Ferguson this time finding Frank Lewis again from 26 yards out, and that made it 24-0 Buffalo, and it looked as if the rout was on. But finally, the Jets got on track just before the intermission with two quick scores. In fact, they scored twice in just over 2 minutes. The Jets' Richard Todd his 26th scoring strike of the year to Mickey Schuler, his first catch of the year. He made it count. It was for a touchdown from 50 yards out, 24-7 with a point after by Pat Leahy, and the Jets were suddenly back in the football game. Then following an interception picked off by Greg Buddle, Pat Leahy connected from 26 yards out, and that gave the Jets 10 to Buffalo's 24, and that's where we are right now at the half. Don't forget, we'll be hearing from Brent Musburger. He'll be talking with the New York Giants coach, Ray Perkins, as we come back in just a moment.
Hi, this is Bob Hope. 1981 was a special year for the American Lung Association. This was the year the Christmas Seal people introduced Freedom from Smoking, a unique plan to help cigarette smokers kick the nicotine habit on their own. The ALA also brought out a very special self-help program for youngsters who have asthma. Super Stuff, a colorful guide for children with asthma that can help them to learn how to live active, normal lives. As the 1981 National Chairman for Christmas Seals, I'm asking you to help support their breath-saving programs. You can do your share by being generous when you answer your Christmas Seal letter and by using Christmas Seals on all your holiday cards, letters, and gift packages. Think of them as a stamp of good health from your American Lung Association. The Christmas Seal people are concerned about your life and breath.
It's 26 degrees and it's snowing, and our forecast says we may have some more of this. Good afternoon, I'm Jeff Januszewski with a halftime update from WROW. Our top story, the Amsterdam City Council refused to do anything to force a new assessment role in the city when it met this morning. Mayor Mario Vila called the aldermen into session after the city assessors signed last year's role back into effect. Ignoring a new role prepared by a city consultant, by a vote of 5-2, the council refused to authorize the city's legal staff to challenge the old role in court.
There's nothing much we can do. What we did this morning was to set the stage so that in the immediate future, when the public wakes up to what has really happened here, and they start searching for the guilty, they will know who is accountable and who isn't.
That is Mayor Vila, who claims the council acted out of political expediency. Well, is it time again to cut off the grain to the Soviet Union? President Carter's defense secretary was Harold Brown, and he feels that even if the status quo is maintained in Poland, the Reagan administration should do more to put pressure on the communists.
I think we should still cut off technology, cut off U.S. exports. That
including
includes
grain.
Specifically grain, because if you don't cut off grain, you're not going to do very much. You're not going to punish the Soviets.
Brown commented on the ABC News program this week. Of course, one of President Reagan's first acts as president was to lift the grain embargo imposed by President Carter. Efforts at mind control are apparently underway in Poland, or ideological purges, as they are called. Teachers and journalists are being forced to sign oaths of loyalty or lose their jobs. Open resistance in Poland is dying down. Even Solidarity sources say most strikes have been crushed, and now they say there's been a good deal more bloodshed than the Polish authorities admit. Fire officials in Catskill are investigating the blaze that extensively damaged the Endicott Johnson and Dan Holt hardware stores on Main Street this morning. They say it looks suspicious. Today's Albany Times Union says the chief of the State Office of Employee Relations wants the law changed so state workers can be laid off for short periods. Meyer Frusher, reportedly concerned about impending permanent firings due to budget shortages, wants to change the civil service law to minimize the firings. The Civil Service Employees Association, which is the biggest union representing state workers, has already said it will strongly oppose that idea. Frusher is Dave DeMaupier's guest tonight at 10 here on WRW's Civic Profile. The Federal Election Commission has overruled its own lawyers in deciding not to take action against Ronald Reagan's campaign organization for keeping $1 million that should have gone to the Republican National Committee. But it was learned today that the bipartisan FEC is considering legal action to recover another $400,000 or so the Reagan organization allegedly misallocated during the campaign. Well, spurred with hope after finding one crew member of a downed Air Force fighter jet on Christmas Eve, authorities today resumed the search for the pilot of the plane. First Lieutenant Thomas Tiller was found drifting in a raft off Charleston, South Carolina. 6 days after his plane crashed in the Atlantic Ocean. Tilla says he never gave up hope, and he's praying for the rescue of the pilot, First Lieutenant Michael Mattson. Energy User News says the Reagan administration is considering an oil import tax that could increase oil prices to consumers by as much as 12 cents a gallon. The news says that several senators have said that the oil import tax may be as high as $2 to $5 a barrel, and that oil companies are sure to pass the cost on to consumers. And the news says the import tax on oil is one of several possible measures the government might apply to reduce the budget deficit. And other oil news today comes from the Middle East Economic Survey. It says Libya is reducing its oil price by 50 cents a barrel for its two top grades. The survey also reports that Iraq will increase its oil production capacity by 2 million barrels a day. Iraq plans to accomplish this by opening five new oil fields. This is news from WROW.
Not again. Trying to get traction where there ain't no treads. I'm an old car with worn-out tires. Liable to kill us both this winter. Maybe we should try some of them new fangled weather tires or some of them special radial winter tires. Something. Treads as low as mine are dangerous, especially in the winter. If nothing else, maybe we should get some tire chains. Winter's action but no traction gives me gas pains.
This was brought to you by the Allstate Network.
In sports, if you've been listening to us, you know that the New York Jets are losing to Buffalo quite handily in the AFC wildcard playoff game. And, of course, later on today on WRW and CBS, the Giants, making their first postseason appearance in 18 years, are in Philadelphia, going against an Eagle team that took runner-up honors in Super Bowl 15. Checking our weather, the forecast for the Capital District this afternoon, cloudy. Chance of occasional snow, and it is snowing, the high around 33. Tonight, periods of snow with possible accumulations of 1 to 3 inches, low near 25. Tomorrow, occasional snow or flurries in the morning, followed by partial clearing in the afternoon, high about 30. Snow chance 50% this afternoon, only 80% tonight, and then tomorrow 60%. Currently, we've got snowy skies and the temperature is 26 degrees. So I'm Jeff Januszewski, and you're up to date on WROW. It is now 1:45, and we're going to return to the AFC wild card game between the New York Jets and the Buffalo Bills with Lindsey Nelson and Dick Stockton and Jim Kelly at Shea Stadium in New York.
Kelly. Jim Kelly, Lindsey Nelson back at Shea Stadium here in New York. The Buffalo Bills clinging to that 14-point lead that once was a 24-0 advantage. Momentum shifting in favor of the Jets. Just before the intermission, they were practically inept over the first 28 minutes, committing three very costly turnovers. One fumble, two interceptions, another interception, negated by the fact that the Bills' defense lined up offsides. It was 24-0 Buffalo early in the football game. And then the Jets came back. Richard Todd to Mickey Schuler, and a 26-yard field goal by Pat Leahy to close the gap to 14 points with 30 minutes left in the regulation. You have to wonder, Lindsey, what the two coaches are talking about at halftime, respectively. Chuck Knox, the veteran coach, has had his team in the playoffs with the Buffalo Bills, with the Rams before that, but has not fared very successfully in postseason play. And, of course, for Walt Michael and his young New York Jet team, this is a new experience. The Jets have not been in the playoffs in 12 years.
They haven't been in the playoffs in 12 years, and when they came out here this afternoon, of course, on the very first play of the ball game, on the fumble, and Chuck Rome's recovery at the 26-yard line, suddenly he is in the end zone, and the Jets were behind in the ball game, and they seemed to die a little bit right there, and it took them a long time to get back into play, and they finally got the 10 points, so I should assume that in the locker rooms right now, both coaches are just trying to get straightened out as to what they'll be going with in the second half here, because as we pointed out many times in the playoffs, this is it. There's nowhere to go if you're the losing team. Now, we'll be back in just a moment.
I'm Charles Hodge with CBS News. We have some good morning listening habits for you on CBS Radio. For starters, there's First Line Report.
I'm Phil Jones, CBS News in Washington, where the big decisions are made, where the political pulse of the nation beats most strongly. On First Line Report, my colleagues Fred Graham, Jed Duvall, Robert Pierpoint, Nelson Benton, and I keep a finger on that pulse Monday through Friday. And also in the morning,
I'm Marshall Loeb, managing editor of Money Magazine with Fewer Dollars. I try to help you make more money through wise investments, keep more of it through tax savings, and spend less of it with wise buying.
Osgood back with you. I visit with you, too, on Newsbreak. I look for stories that may not make the headlines, but could make you sit up and take notice. Some good morning listening habits to get into Monday through Friday. First Line Report, Your Dollars, and Newsbreak. On most of these CBS Radio Network stations. Hear them here.
The New York Jets and the Buffalo Bills have made their way through the tunnel and have taken their respective sidelines and are warming up. The Jets on the near sideline, the Bills across the way. Watching Richard Todd as he's warming up over on the near sideline. Richard was injured just before the end of the first half. He's tossing over to Mickey Schuler, who has a touchdown catch. But Richard appears to be okay. He went down, was clinging to that left knee, stayed in the ball game, and came back and got the Jets back into field goal range after that interception by Greg Buddle. And he appears to be okay, Lindsey, as we watch him on the near sideline right now. He, of course, would be a very key ingredient should he go out. Pat Ryan is the backup. He's 4 years out of Tennessee, so you know something about this former volunteer.
He is the backup who hasn't had any great deal of playing time, of course, and backing up Richard Todd, who is usually in there. We've just had the officials come out now and indicate that the Jets will be kicking off and that Buffalo will be receiving to start playing the second half here at Shea Stadium in New York. And right down the middle of the field, it looks a little muddy when ball players have been in that area. They've been a little skidding here and there, and it's because of the fact that we've had some misting rainfall and their umbrellas and foul weather gear spread around down below us just now. Season's greetings to you and your family listening across the country to CBS Radio and overseas on American Forces Radio.
All even in first downs at 7. The Jets in rushing, just 18 yards on the ground. The Bills, 11. Big difference, of course, in passing. Buffalo, 190 yards. The New York Jets, 143. So there's about a 40-yard edge in total yardage. The Bills, 201. The Jets, 161. Time of possession was even up. Ironically, Lindsey, as you and I were talking while we were away listening to Brent, the Buffalo Bills had actually been outpossessed in terms of time of possession by the Jets. It was 8 minutes to about 6 minutes at one point, but the Bills, because of those turnovers, led it 17-0. A time of possession is always a very deceiving statistic. It matters not how long you have the ball, but what you do when you've got it.
Exactly, and now the ball is being teed up on the 35-yard line, and it'll be the Jets kicking it off. Pat Leahy is setting it up on the tee, and Curtis Brown has dropped back with Rob Riddick to receive it for the Buffalo Bills. As we start play here in the second half at Shea Stadium, the Buffalo Bills are leading the New York Jets by a score of 24-10. Referee Bob McElwee indicates he's ready. There's the whistle. Here comes Leahy. Fails it downfield, and it's over to Rob Riddick's side. At the 4-yard line, he's back to the 5, to the 10, to the 15, heading toward midfield, to the 20, 25, and out to the 26, possibly 27-yard line. Rob Riddick on the return.
Now, I don't want you to panic, but I want to point out that neither the statistician nor the spotter have come back.
Well, I tell you, we are on sort of a cold and windy promontory out here, and I can't say that I blame them. First down and 10 yards to go for the Buffalo Bills with the ball at their own 26-yard line as it's spotted. Joe Ferguson, of course, the quarterback. He has quarterbacked them throughout. Man who has thrown 24 touchdown passes this year coming into this ball game here this afternoon. As Joe Cribbs has Roosevelt Leak. His running backs in there even up. Wide receivers left and right. That's Butler and Lewis. Ferguson still waiting. He's got it. Gives it off, and the defense of the Jets pours through. Gain of about a yard on the play.
Joe Cribbs again cut down by Stan Blinka there. Of course, the front four of the Jets, Gastineau, Abdul Salam, Marty Lyons, and Joe Klecko. The linebackers are Buddle, Blinka, and company. And the secondary, Donald Dykes, Jerry Holmes, Ken Schroy has an interception, and Darrell Ray.
Second down, 9 yards to go. The ball at the 27 now. Dan Ferguson is up there waiting for the snap. Wide receivers left and right. Ferguson drops back to look.
Yes, Sam throws, and Bremer can't hang on. Bremer tried a diving catch. It's back to the inside, so it is incomplete. It'll be third down and 9 yards to go with the ball at the 27-yard line.
Well, one out of two is not bad. The statistician's back. The spotter's still going. What did that usher tell you about these seats at Shea Stadium at baseball time?
He said that most people stayed here just a minute or two and left when they came into these seats. They were not used a great deal. This will be third down and 9 yards to go. Ball at the 27-yard line, and here come the Buffalo Bills up there once again. And Jerry Shea trying to exhort the defense of the New York Jets. Shotgun formation. Ferguson waiting to get the direct snap. Got it. Drops back. Looks. Moves out of the pocket and throws on the run. And it is Frank Lewis with a catch. Frank Lewis made the grab up near the 40-yard line. Well, they took a look now to see about the proximity of the six to see if he picked up a first down.
There is the poise of a Joe Ferguson, a veteran out of Arkansas in his ninth year, the former Razorback, chased somewhat out of the pocket by the front four, the sack exchange, if you will. Klecko putting some pressure on. He was finally chopped down. Ferguson rolling out to the right side, threw the ball on a string, knew that his receiver, number 82, Frank Lewis, an 11-year veteran out of Grambling, would have enough sense to come back toward the ball. He was covered. It was man-on-man coverage, and then Lewis was down at about the 43, came back toward the ball, and that enabled Ferguson to find him and pick up a big Buffalo first down.
At the 36-yard line, they're up there in an eye formation, the eighth first down of the ball game for the Buffalo Bills. Ferguson now handing it off to Cribbs. Cribbs starts the right side. Struggles in across the 40-yard line to the 41-yard line for five. It'll be second down and 5 yards to go at the 41. Joe Cribbs carrying.
Cribbs, who's rushed for over 1,000 yards in two consecutive seasons. That's his fifth carry this afternoon. A total of just 12 yards. He carried it four times in the first half for 8 yards. Second-year man out of Auburn.
Buffalo Bills again convene their huddle.
The reason, of course, it was a big first down for the Buffalo Bills on that pass reception by number 82, Frank Lewis, it keeps the drive alive, keeps the ball away from the Jets because the momentum just before the end of the first half shifting to New York's favor.
Exactly. And now the Bills are up there once again. Giving it off to Roosevelt Leakes. He tries the right side and gets across the 45-yard line. Struggling to try to get to the sticks, but he's a little short, I think. Just stretched his body out across the 45-yard line. The length of the football across the line. Lance Mayall and Joe Klecko made the tackle.
Leakes, former Longhorn out of Texas in his seventh year, has been around the league. Actually, more effective in the first half as a pass receiver. Had seven pass catches on the year coming in. Caught three in the first half. Roosevelt Leakes did. Caught five in the first half for a total of 23 yards. Only carried the ball three times for 5 yards.
Big play here. Third and one at the 46-yard line. Buffalo Bills in their own territory. Cribbs and Leakes at the setbacks. Here is Leak. Powers in. I think he got it. They use him on short yardage, and he is effective. The former Longhorn of the University of Texas got it up to the 48-yard line for first and 10. That's first down number 9 for the Buffalo Bills.
You must have seen Roosevelt Leakes in a Cotton Bowl or two.
I did, in fact, when he was playing for Darrell Royal at the University of Texas. First down, 10 yards to go. We're in the third quarter here at Shea Stadium.
12 minutes, inside 12 when the ball is snapped. Of course, the Bills would like some kind of a long ball possession, time-consuming drive. Work on that clock a little bit and keep the ball away from Richard Todd and the New York Jets.
Frank Lewis on a wide right, Jerry Butler on a wide left. Bremer tight end right, dropping back is Ferguson. And he throws to Bremer. Tight end across to the 48-yard line, was hit immediately and thrown back to about the midfield marker. The hit was made by Dykes. Now the ball is taken to the mid to the inbounds marker and spotted at the 49-yard line of the New York Jets for a gain of 3, which will make it second and 7 at the 49.
Bremer, the second-year tight end out of Michigan State, had one catch in the first half for 14 yards. Ferguson now 14 out of 22, 225 yards, two touchdowns, one interception. Again, the key thing to watch is that New York sack exchange, their front four, Klecko, Gastineau, and company, against the offensive line of the Buffalo Bills, and again, the Bills' offensive line taking command.
The Bills, in their initial possession of this second half, are keeping the football. They lead 24-10. Running backs are evened up. Ferguson dropping back again. Takes a look. Penalty marker thrown. He completes the pass to Leak to the right side, 45-40, and down to the 38-yard line. A penalty marker to be checked out. Roosevelt Leak out in the flat, took the pass.
This will be coming back.
Holding is indicated against Buffalo.
You wonder just how long Buffalo could keep the Jets and their front four off of Joe Ferguson's back. There's an injured New York Jet down at about the 42-yard line. The field has been extremely slippery. The footing has been treacherous. Of course, an advantage to the wide receivers since they know where they're going.
Holding, number 73, offense, second down.
John Borchert detected holding, and this is an injury timeout we have here now.
Six penalties, 35 yards against the Buffalo Bills.
Ken Troy, it is, I think, shaking up on the play for the Jets, and he's getting attention. So with the score, Buffalo 24, the Jets 10, let's take timeout.
On city streets and country roads,
international,
making deliveries, hauling loads,
international.
The number one name in trucks means saving for you.
International.
A recent fuel efficiency test proved that over a four-year period, an International XL Series heavy truck can save thousands of fuel dollars over a comparably equipped Kenworth or Freightliner. And that can mean thousands of dollars of extra profit to a business. But no matter what business you're in, International's finding ways to lower your trucking costs and improve your profits. See your International dealer soon to find out just how much you can save with International.
Whatever job's got to be done, International can cost you less to run. We're the number one name in trucks, International.
Buffalo Bills continue their road show. They, of course, finished up the regular season with a loss 16-6. To the Dolphins down in the Orange Bowl in Miami a week ago when they were frustrated again. They hadn't won in the Orange Bowl since 1966.
Second down, 17 yards to go for the Bills. They held the ball at their own 41 with that holding penalty having been inflicted. They split the running back. Wide receivers left and right. Joe Ferguson back to throw. Pumps it and it is incomplete to Crimson, almost intercepted. Crimson popped it up into the air and it was almost intercepted. Into a bunch of green jerseys there. So make it third down and 17 at the 41-yard line.
Number 51 was back on the coverage, Greg Buddle for the New York Jets. He had one interception already in the football game. Ferguson that time threw it behind Cribbs, the intended receiver, and it was almost picked off. So it's third down, 17 to go, 10:40 left in the third quarter. We talk about the Bills and their road show. This is their fourth game on the road. They began in San Diego where they won 28-27. They beat the New England Patriots at Foxborough 19-10, then lost at Miami, and they continue on the road here at Shea. The reason, of course, the weather in Buffalo this time of year can get a little nasty.
Word on Ken Troy is that he was simply winded, so apparently he'll be all right. Third and 17. Dropping back now is Ferguson again. Up the middle, and it's intercepted at the 45 by Buddle. Greg Buddle returns it to the 50 to the 45. First and 10 for the Jets at the Buffalo 45-yard line on Greg Buddle's interception.
That's the second interception of the football game for Buddle, and again it stops a Buffalo drive and gives the New York Jets good field position. You talk about turnovers being a factor. It very definitely was a factor. The Buffalo Bills rolled up 24 unanswered points and led, but now momentum and two of Buddle's interceptions have swung the pendulum the other way. When the Buffalo Bills were winning four games in a row, they cut down on their turnover tendency. And when they lost to the Miami Dolphins, they had three turnovers. So you can see what a difference it does make. We'll be back in just a moment.
At Mama Grisanti's restaurant in Louisville, Kentucky, blind people don't have to ask what's on the menu. They can read it themselves in Braille. The Braille menus are there because a group of local people thought it would be a good idea. They got together and made it happen. In fact, all across America, both disabled and non-disabled people are participating in similar community programs. in Vernon Parish, Louisiana. They're modifying disabled people's homes to make them more accessible. And in Champaign, Illinois, disabled children are able to share a playground because a group of volunteers got involved. This is the International Year of Disabled Persons. Is this the year you get involved? Call the office of your mayor or county commissioner for more information.
A public service on behalf of the U.S. Council for the International Year of Disabled Persons from the Ad Council and this station.
Jets have the ball. Todd with a play action now. Sets up the throw, throws out the right flat. And it is taken out there by Schuler. And the tight end is struggling on downfield. He gets down to about the 35-yard line. Lucius Sanford finally dragged him out, pulling him by the arm. Schuler losing a part of his jersey.
Let's pause now 5 seconds for our stations to identify themselves on the CBS Radio Network.
NFL football action is yours here on WROW Albany.
Mickey Schuler, 2 catches, 38 yards, 1 touchdown on the afternoon so far. Took a little swing at number 57, Lucius Sanford, out of bounds. Sanford, a 4-year man out of Georgia Tech, but the Jets have good field position.
Second down and 1 yard to go. They have it at the Bills' 35-yard line. Buffalo leading 24-10 in the third quarter. Jets trying to battle back here. Now Todd is angling left, looking downfield, and he's going to run it. He's got the first down at the 30, goes on down near the 25-yard line. Richard Todd, 8th first down of the ball game for the Jets. Isaiah Robertson made the stop. First down and 10 yards to go at the 25-yard line.
And that word momentum again has definitely gone in favor of the New York Jets with that second interception by Buttle, that time a bootleg. And Todd just rolling out to the left side, got out of the grasp of Sherman White, the 11-year man out of California. And bad knee and all, still managed to run for a first down.
Walker going to a wide right now. They bring the running backs in an I formation. Now they split them out. Newton in the right set. Freeman McNeil in the left set. Gaffney is in the slot right. Richard Todd waiting. Gives it to Freeman McNeil. He slips on the cut. Picks up 2, possibly 3, maybe more. Gets down near the 20-yard line. Driving forward, Phil Villapiano made the stop. It's at the 21-yard line for a gain of 4, making second down and 6 yards to go.
7 carries, just 9 yards for Freeman McNeil, who had 93 yards rushing against the Baltimore Colts earlier this year. The rookie out of UCLA, the former Bruin. Excellent acceleration. He's 5'11", a very powerful back. He's 220. He carries it well. Good legs.
Kevin Long is brought in the next play. Stays in there at fullback. He's in the left set now. Freeman McNeil in the right set. Richard Todd going to a high count, gets the ball. Handing it off to Long. Kevin Long jitterbugs his way inside the 20-yard line. Trying to get up to the first down stick. He's up there very close. They get him unstacked to get the ball spotted now. Jets are getting a lot of fan support. It's going to be third down and about a yard to go.
The Jets are a very young team. Randy Rasmussen, number 66, has been here 15 years, the veteran out of Kearney State. He played on the Super Bowl team with Joe Namath, Don Maynard, and company. And the other man with 10 years' experience, Jerome Barkham. Other than that, this is a very young team.
Third and one, Scott Jerkington on the right set, Kevin Long's in the left set. Third down and 1 yard to go. Kevin Long, first and 10, inside the 10-yard line. He hurdled his way forward. Picked up the first down and kept driving inside the 10 to about the 8-yard line.
Joe Fields, number 65. Dan Alexander, number 60. Marvin Powell, 79. The right wall of the Jets' offensive line. Controlling and, in fact, dominating line of scrimmage on this game. The 9th first down for the Jets. They're getting back into this football game. You talk about a young football team. Sometimes you fall behind as they did. They would quit. It'd be easy to when you're falling behind 24-0. But when you're young and aggressive, you don't know you're supposed to do things like that. You try to fight your way back, and that's what the Jets have been doing.
First down and goal to go at the 8-yard line. Newton and McNeil in the setbacks now. Here's Freeman McNeil trying to go to the right side, cutting back. Stretches his body out down near the 5-yard line. Freeman McNeil carrying. For the New York Jets, it'll be second down and goal to go.
If and when the Jets score, this crowd will come to life once again. They are now, but it'll be nothing like you'll hear when the Jets defense takes the field to try to thwart the next Buffalo drive. Buffalo had a 24-0 lead. If the Jets get a touchdown, if they punch it in here, that lead will be cut down to 7 points with a lot of time left in this football game. McNeil now limping off slowly over on the near sideline.
Second down and goal to go inside the five-yard line. Durking is in there at the right set now. Kevin Long's in the left set. Richard Todd waits for the snap. He's got it. Gives it to Long. Trying to pick his way. He got a yard or so down to about the two-yard line. It'll be third down and goal to go. Kevin Long carrying on the last play down to the two-yard line.
Seven carries, 27 yards for Kevin Long, number 33. That Jets offensive line, Randy Rasmussen, wears a Super Bowl ring. He'd like a shot at another one before he retires. And now the Jets and the crowd coming to life now on third and a very short yard.
Harper's coming to the ball game. Long and Harper are the setbacks in there now.
Look at the security guards here at Shea Stadium. They're up on their feet. The ones down on the field that are ringing the stadium are exhorting the crowd, too. And Richard Todd, he can't hear the signals, and there's a little mix-up.
They call a timeout. The Jets indicate they want to call timeout. So with timeout on the field, we'll be back in just a moment.
Has problems, that is true, but here's our season's wish for you. The peace and goodwill just might yet work. Season's cheer from the CBS Radio Network.
With that word of cheer from CBS News correspondent Charles Osgood, we bring you greetings from two other Charleses, Gerald and Crawford. From Steve Young, Phil Jones, Ed Bradley, Fred Graham, Nelson Benton, and David Jackson. Morton, Reed Collins, Richard C. Hodlett, Douglas Edwards, Dallas Townsend, Deborah Potter, and Christopher Glenn. And from everyone else at the CBS Radio Network.
Freeman McNeil, eight carries, just 14 yards over on the Jets sideline. He is the outside speed, so you would obviously key on number 33, Kevin Long, the power back of the New York Jets, as it's third and a yard to go. 6:01 to go in the third quarter. The Jets on the verge of putting some points on the board, the first score of the second stanza.
Here come the Jets now out of the huddle up to the line. Third down goal to go at the two. Long and Harper are the setbacks. Wide receivers to the left side. They string them out. Motion to the left side. Now rolling right is Todd. Todd drives forward, but he's hit just about the line of scrimmage, or maybe a foot or so. As they sent all the motion to the left side, Todd rolled right, but nothing was there. Mike Cady saved the tackle. Fourth down and goal to go for the Jets. Crowd says go for it.
And I think Walt Michael is. This is an interesting call right now. Now he changes his mind. He was discussing the play call. If it were up near a yard, I think they might have gone for it. But actually, Todd lost some yardage on the play. The Bills defense had that one sniffed out completely. They pinched the two ends, and they were having just one job in mind. That was contain Richard Todd. Let the linebackers in the secondary worry about the wide receivers. You don't let Todd get outside the containment. They knew what play Walt Michaels was going with, and they had sniffed it out.
20-yard field goal attempt for Leahy with Ryan holding. It's down, it is up, and it's good. 3 points on the board for the New York Jets. So with the score, Buffalo 24, the Jets 13. Let's take timeout.
This bud's for all those hardworking folks who turn halftime into showtime. Yeah, here's to the marching band.
Bud's for you. There's no one else who does it quite the way you do. So here's to you. You know it isn't only what you say, it's what you do.
That's right, for every member of the band, that distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
You gotta agree, Jack. Anybody who can stay in step while playing a tuba deserves a cold Bud.
It's Bud's for you. For all you do, the king of beers is coming through.
You play tuba?
tuba, Hank?
No, but I've had coaching days when I wished I could.
This bug's for you.
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis.
You know, AFC Eastern teams have not won a playoff game in 8 years, but that obviously will end this afternoon when the Jets and Buffalo play each other. We'll have to have a winner here. The winner advances to meet the Cincinnati Bengals next Sunday afternoon at Riverfront Stadium. Talk about the AFC East. This is also the first time that three teams from the same division, the AFC East, Miami, the Jets, and Buffalo, and from the NFC East, Dallas, Philadelphia, and the Giants, have qualified for the playoffs.
Here comes Leahy to kick it off. Riddick and Brown are deep for Buffalo. It's over to Rob Riddick's side of the field. He has it at the 2-yard line. Rob Riddick to the 5, to the 10, cuts back toward midfield to the 15, struggles out across the 20. So the Buffalo Bills will start at 1st and 10. At that point, Tom Newton made the stop.
Let's check the stats on Joe Ferguson now, see what Joe Ferguson will work with. 12 out of 24, 2 touchdowns. But more importantly, the 2 interceptions right now. More importantly, if you're the New York Jets, because the momentum has swung in favor of the Jets, you have to wonder if Joe's going to be a little bit conservative here, a little bit snake bit. The last 2 balls that were picked off were not well thrown. He started to throw high and behind his receivers, so we'll have to watch.
They started 1st and 10 at the 22-yard line. Running backs are well split. Ferguson waiting for the snap now. Goes to a high count, drops back. Passing on 1st down, he takes a look, zips it, and it's almost intercepted by Buttle. He dropped the ball. Buttle had it right in his hands because the receiver was down. It was intended for Roosevelt Leach, and it's batted down incomplete. It'll be 2nd and 10.
Boy, if you're a Buffalo fan, you've got to be getting awfully nervous right now. Joe Ferguson hooking up with Greg Buttle the last 3 passes. 2 have gone for interceptions, and that one should have been. The offensive line held their pass protection that time. Leaks fell down, but actually the ball was thrown right into the midsection of Buttle.
So it is 2nd and 10 at the 22-yard line. Running backs are well split once again. Cribbs and Roosevelt Leaks. Wide receivers left and right for Joe Ferguson. He's got it, dropping back to set up and look. Throws it, and it is taken by Cribbs over his shoulder, and he goes across the 25 and out of bounds as he got up across the 30-yard line. Greg Buttle ran him out of bounds. See exactly where he stepped out. It'll be taken at the inbound marker and spotted there, and it's going to be spotted at the 29-yard line.
Greg Buttle having quite a season here this afternoon. He has 2 interceptions on the year, both of them coming this afternoon. So it's 3rd down and 3. That's an interesting call for Ferguson and company. 3rd down conversions. The Bills are 1 out of 6.
3rd and 3 at the 29-yard line. Here come the Bills. Again, the fans are trying to assist the defense of the Jets on the big 3rd down. Buffalo going into the shotgun. It'll be a direct snap to Joe Ferguson. Hooks is in there. Ball is taken by Ferguson. He drops back. Throws right, and it's taken by Cribbs. It's up at the 35-40. 45, and stopped at the 47-yard line. 1st and 10 for the Buffalo Bills. On the crucial 3rd down completion, Buttle and Ray made the tackle. 10th 1st down for the Buffalo Bills.
So Buffalo now 2 out of 7 on 3rd down conversions. That's what you try to do, is just slide at Joe Cribbs. Excellent speed out of Auburn. The back on the linebacker one-on-one. He beat Buttle badly to the outside. Buttle did a smart thing, though. He knew he had a couple of cornerbacks coming up to help him make the tackle. So while he was grabbing Cribbs around the arm with one arm, he tried to strip Joe of the football with the other. Cribbs hung on. 1st down Bills. 4:20 to go. 3rd quarter and counting. 24-13. Buffalo clinging now to an 11-point lead. At one time, it was 24-zip.
Buffalo up there, 1st and 10. Wide receivers left and right. Running back split. Ferguson again waiting. Leave it on the ground this time. And it's advanced to the 50-yard line. Gain of about 3 yards on the play will make it 2nd down and 7 yards to go. Joe Cribbs carrying.
Abdul Salam with an ankle tackle, the 6-year man out of Kent State. Otherwise, Cribbs had a lot of room to run that time. They opened up the hole. Salam was blocked up, but he just got a hand on Cribbs' ankle and chopped him down low.
Buffalo Bills leading in the ballgame by a score of 24-13. The Jets have scored 13 unanswered points. After Buffalo had taken a 24-0 lead, we're in the 3rd quarter, and here come the Bills, sending Jerry Butler to the left side, Frank Lewis to the right side. split the running back. Cribbs and Leak. Ferguson drops back to set up. Look. Can't find anybody. He scrambles out. And he's sacked. He's pulled on back to the 35-yard line.
That's the first sack for the sack exchange of New York. The Jets, Klecko, Gastineau and company, that front four, they've been awesome. They lead the NFL in sacks with a total of 66. Meanwhile, the Bills came in permitting only 16 sacks all year. Three of those came in the two games against the New York Jets. A huge loss of yardage for the Buffalo Bills. There's an injured Jet down at about the 35-yard line.
The officials have stopped the clock, so this is an injury delay. Our members of the training staff come out.
It was Klecko, number 73, the five-year former Temple Owl, who got to Ferguson and would check the injury. You'll hear all of the Super Bowl excitement. It's Super Bowl 16 right here on CBS Radio Sports, Sunday, January the 24th. Jack Buck and Hank Stram will be up at the Silver Dome in Pontiac, Michigan. Super Bowl 16 begins at 3:45 Eastern Time on Super Sunday here on CBS Sports. Hear it here. Speaking of Jack Buck and Hank Stram, they're standing by at Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. The Eagles play host to the New York Giants. That game at 3:15 Eastern Time over many of these same CBS Radio Network stations. That's Mark Gastineau, number 99, who is leaving under his own power, a member of the sack exchange, who was cut down near the line of scrimmage, the third-year man out of East Central Oklahoma. He is 6'5", 276. He is big, and he is quick.
And we're ready to continue as the ball is marked ready for play. It is third and 23 for the Buffalo Bills, the ball at their own 33. So another big play in this ball game. With 3 minutes, 7 seconds left to play in the third quarter.
Lindsey, the entire third quarter, Ferguson has been throwing right. He's not looked to his left at all. Let's see if he comes back to the left side and looks for either Butler or Jesse.
All right, they're up there in the shotgun once again. He waits for the direct snap from center. Gets it. Dropping back and looking. Scrambling out to the right side, and again, he gets way back there near the 8-yard line and unloads it, and it is complete. It's intercepted at the 41-yard line. Return to the 35, to the 25. Penalty marker thrown. It is at the 20, and it's being returned by Dykes, and he finally goes out of bounds on the far side of the field. Dykes intercepted and returned.
It's going to be clipping against the New York Jets, but the interception will stand. Chopped down at about the 20-yard line was number 93 for the New York Jets, Marty Lyons, the third-year back or lineman from Alabama. Ferguson had absolutely, positively no business throwing that football. Klecko chased him out of the pocket, aided by Marty Lyons. Ferguson came back and badly underthrew the ball. Joe might have been trying to throw it away, but stepping in front, Donald Dykes, the third-year man from Southeast Louisiana. And the Jets, even though they will be called for clipping, will still have excellent field position and are right back very definitely.
Personal foul, clipping number 74 on the run back. First down.
Abdul Salam on the run back. First and 10 Jets.
At the 36-yard line of the Buffalo Bills, first and 10. And now Bob McElwee has it all straight as the Jets are ready to deploy their offense. Running backs are evened up for Richard Todd. Freeman McNeil takes the handoff, hits in there, and drives down to the 31-yard line. Freeman McNeil, the rookie from UCLA, picks up 5 on the play. It'll be second down and 5 yards to go. 24-13, the Buffalo Bills leading with the clock running 2 minutes 16 seconds left in the third quarter.
Lindsey, of the 8 times that the two teams have scored here this afternoon, 6 of those times, interceptions and fumbles, had led directly to those scores.
All right, they even up the running backs. Kevin Long is in there with Freeman McNeil. They're on a slot right. Again, Richard Todd to Freeman McNeil. Drives, keeps his feet, spins, and gets down to the 28-yard line. Maybe a yard more. Rod Kush made the stop. They take a long look to the sideline now, and it's going to be third down and about 2 yards to go.
McNeil, 10 carries, 23 yards. Key third down play for the Buffalo Bills defensive unit. They've been hampered primarily by the offense. The offense keeps giving the ball back. Ferguson now intercepted three times in the afternoon.
Third down about a yard and a half inside the 30-yard line.
Jets are 3 out of 10 on third down conversions.
Now contact made before the snap. So flags are thrown.
Right side of the Jet offensive front move.
The officials go into conference now. Before announcing the penalty, it is against the Jets, says McElwee. That will be a costly penalty coming on a third and 1.5. Puts the ball back at the 32-yard line.
Fourth start, number 61, offense, third down.
So now at the 32-yard line of Buffalo, the Jets have the ball third down and near 7 to go. Moving up to the line once again. Shuler's the tight end right. Harper and Durking are in there, both good receivers. Richard Todd waits for the snap. Now Todd dropping back, takes a look, throws left, and it is taken at the sideline. A completed pass will be enough for the first down. Taken by Walker, and he went right out of bounds. Wesley Walker. First and 10 is brought in and spotted outside, just outside the 20-yard line.
Straight drop that time by Richard Todd. Simply a down and out pattern by Walker. 5-year veteran in the NFL. And the man he turned around and beat, Mario Clark, the 6-year veteran out of Oregon, who has an interception so far this afternoon. So the Buffalo defense must assert themselves now. Keep the Jets off that scoreboard. 1:08 left to go in the third quarter, and the Jets are driving.
Gaffney and Walker to the right side. First down and 10 yards to go. Freeman McNeil gets the handoff, breaks one tackle, struggles back just inside the 20-yard line. Almost lost 2 or 3 yards as he slipped on a cut, was hit, broke the tackle, and drove just inside the 20. Picked up at most a yard.
Freeman actually slipped just as he was handed the ball by Richard Todd. And Richard Todd went immediately to the referee and was screaming that McNeil might have been partially grabbed by the face mask. Todd was very upset. McNeil actually picked up a yard on the play. Second down and 9. Todd is 13 of 25 now.
McNeil comes off the field and Bruce Harper comes racing on now. Scott Durkin comes racing on. Second and 9 at the 19. Now Durkin hits for the sideline. They had too many out there for the moment. Dropping back. Here's Richard Todd. Throws up the middle and intercepted by the Buffalo Bills. And returned to the 20-yard line. So the Bills take it over. It was Bill Simpson who intercepted, slipped down, got up, no contact, and advanced it. So that stops the drive of the New York Jets and gives the ball to the Buffalo Bills. First down and 10 yards to go. 17 seconds on the clock. Remaining to be played in the third quarter, and Buffalo is leading by a score of 24-13.
So very suddenly, all the quarterbacks, both quarterbacks in this game, have been picked off three times. Simpson, that's his fourth interception of the year, the 7-year former Spartan out of Michigan State, a key ingredient of the Buffalo Bills defense. Of course, the Bills were champions in the AFC East last year before being ousted by the San Diego Chargers. This is the seventh time the Bills have been in postseason game. They're 2-4 in their previous playoff appearances, with their last win a 23-0 whitewash over the Chargers in the AFC Championship in 1965. But on the road this year, the Bills a disastrous 3-5 mark.
Buffalo will have the ball first and 10. They'll have it at their own 19-yard line when play is resumed here at Shea Stadium.
Tell me about your Cotton Bowl preview that you're working on for us here at CBS.
Well, we're working on the Cotton Bowl preview, which will involve, of course, Alabama and the University of Texas, with a few highlights of each of those teams during the regular season and an interview here and there to get things all set for the playing of the Cotton Bowl game in Dallas, Texas.
Well, that'll be on Thursday, New Year's Eve, on CBS Radio. Then you can hear the Cotton Bowl game, Alabama against Texas, at 2 o'clock Eastern time on New Year's Day. And we'll tell you more about the NFL action next Saturday and Sunday after this play.
Leaks and Cribs. Here's the handoff to Leaks, and he drives the right side, and he gets just about to the 20 for a yard, and that's all, as he is hit by Gastineau. It'll be second and 9.
Saturday on January the 2nd, NFC Divisional Playoff action. Tampa Bay at Dallas, Jack Buck and Roman Gabriel at 12:45 Eastern Time. The AFC Divisional game, San Diego against Miami. From the Orange Bowl, Lindsey and I will be there at 4:45. And then on Sunday, it'll be the Jets or Buffalo at Cincinnati at 12:45. And the Giants or the Eagles at San Francisco at 4:45, all here on CBS Radio.
And time has run out in this period. Before they could run another play, time expired in this quarter. And so that's the end of the third quarter with the score, Buffalo 24 and the New York Jets 13.
To increase a car's fuel efficiency, some cars have undergone drastic reductions in room and comfort.
You're right, sir. It is smaller than last year's model, but let's just say it's our little way of bringing the family closer together.
Buick's Regal Coupe has retained both its luxury and fuel efficiency with an aerodynamic design that helps Regal's 21 EPA estimated MPG. Use estimated MPG for comparison. Actual mileage may be different. Estimates lower in California. The Regal Coupe.
Wouldn't you really rather have a Buick?
Sports lovers, turn us on because CBS has the most exciting sports programming in radio. Regular sportscasts with Win Elliott, Jim Kelly, Kurt Gowdy, Lynn Berman, Bill Schweitzer, Howard David, and me, Brent Musburger. Special live coverage of the big ones, NFL football, baseball's All-Star Game, the World Series, U.S. Open Tennis, Masters Golf. And you're in the right spot for all the local sports news, too. So sports lovers, turn us on and hear it here.
Jim Kelly, Lindsey Nelson back for the final 15 minutes in regulation. The New York Jets trying to get back into the thick of the hunt. They trail it by 11, 24-13. Big interception by Bill Simpson, the veteran out of Michigan State, to give the Buffalo Bills the ball. Lindsey, contrast the first half for Joe Ferguson, where he was 12 out of 19, two touchdowns and one interception, with a disastrous second half performance, four out of seven for just 38 yards and two interceptions.
And here we go with the fourth quarter, second and nine for Buffalo. They have the ball just short of their own 20-yard line. Ferguson up there running back to the nine, gives it off to Joe Cribbs. He tries the left side, 20, 25, and out to the 30-yard line. Joe Cribbs carrying that ball with both hands, grasping it firmly. Jerry Holmes in to make the tackle. They take a long look for the possible first down. Out, it is a first and 10.
Joe Cribbs, that's his seventh carry of the afternoon, 25 yards, the 11th first down picked up by the Buffalo Bills. They'll start to work on that clock right now, Lindsey, protecting that 11-point lead a little bit. The New York Jets are tied for the lowest amount of points allowed in the fourth quarter, 57 over a 16-game season coming in. So they know that that sack exchange defense and company can be extremely tough, maybe a little more so here at Shea in front of the home folks.
Here they come now, wide receivers left and right. It's Butler to the left side, Lewis to the right side, running backs in an I formation. Ferguson handing it off to Cribbs again, up the middle this time. Gets 5, 6, 7, 8 yards. More than that, he's out near the 40-yard line. Just kept right on struggling, and so Butler was the man who came in to bring him down. It's going to be second down and about a yard to go.
Nine rushes now, 34 yards for Joe Cribbs. He carried four times in the first half. 8 yards. So you can see he wasn't involved that much in the offense, at least on the ground. He did have a couple of catches, two for 38 yards in the first half. Blink in there on the tackle, third-year man out of Sam Houston State. So now, this is a good waist down when you've got it second and just 1 yard to go. This would be a good time to go up top.
Here they come, evening up the running back. Ferguson bending in to take the snap. He's got it, leaves it on the ground to Cribbs. He tries the right side. He wants the first down, and he got that. If he got across the 40-yard line, it'll be first and 10 at the 41, the 12th first down of the ball game for the Buffalo Bills. As that clock keeps running, it's down to 13 minutes and 10 seconds left in the game.
Gastineau in there on the tackle, number 99. He is 6'5", 276, third-year veteran out of East Central Oklahoma. He left on the last series, you recall, just before the end of the third quarter. He is back in there. He's a key ingredient for the sack exchange. Joe Klecko, that front four of the New York Jets defensively. Marty Lyons, Abdul Salam.
Buffalo in no great hurry, coming slowly up to the line now with the running back split. Joe Ferguson, the quarterback, has been in there all day long at the controls. He drops back now, takes a look and throws to the right side, and it is taken up near the 40-yard line. Frank Lewis took it and was hit immediately and went across the sideline marker. That'll be a first and 10 at the 41-yard line of the New York Jets.
So Ferguson now is 4 out of 8 in the second half. He found his favorite receiver, Frank Lewis, and what an afternoon he's having. 7 catches over 150 yards and 2 touchdowns. Again, that corner route, you go down about 18, 20 yards and turn it to the outside. He did. He had 6 catches and 109 yards in the second game against the New York Jets this year, a game the Jets won.
Lewis coming to the left side. Jerry Butler to the right side. The running back stay in the I formation. They give it to Cribbs off the tailback. He cuts back and gets inside the 40 to the 38-yard line. He picks up 3 yards on the play. It'll be second down and 7 yards to go. Marty Lyons made the tackle for the New York Jets.
Lyons in his third year out of Alabama, 6'5", 269. Boy, you take a look at that front wall. Gastineau is 6'5", 276. Lyons is 6'5", 269. Abdul Salam is no youngster in there either. Big guy is number 74. He's 6'3", 269. And, of course, Joe Klecko, former Owl, coached by Wayne Harden at Temple, 6'3", 267.
Second down play coming now with a running back split for Joe Ferguson. Dropping back. Takes a look and throws to the right side to Roosevelt. Leaks incomplete. Buttle was covering defensively. It'll be third down and 7 yards to go at the 38-yard line.
That time, Ferguson did the wise thing. He didn't try to force the ball to Leaks. Leaks was open for a moment, but Blinka putting some pressure on, and Greg Buttle, 51. Buttle came over there quickly with good speed and actually stepped in front of Leaks. The ball was too far beyond either one of them. Otherwise, it would have been the third interception. Buffalo 2 out of 7 now on third down conversion.
Big third down play coming now. Joe Klecko getting a hand as he comes off the field. Kenny Neal has replaced him. Here come the Buffalo Bills up to the line in a shotgun formation. Ferguson will get a direct snap. Wide receivers left and right. Ferguson's got the ball. Goes to Butler, and it is intercepted by the Jets at the 23-yard line. The Jets pick it off, and they'll have it first and 10. So that ended the drive of the Buffalo Bills as the New York Jets have intercepted it. Jerry Holmes with the football, and so it'll be a first and 10. Let's give our stations a chance for a message. We'll be back in just a moment.
It's College Bowl time once again, and WROW is proud to bring you all the exciting action of the Fiesta Bowl, starring Penn State and the Trojans of USC. Then it's the majestic Rose Bowl with the Iowa Hawkeyes versus the Huskies of Washington. Don't miss it. Hear all the action here at WROW Sports Central, beginning at 1:20 on New Year's Day.
There's a kid at the window.
Fire. It's deadly. Children are frightened and fascinated by it. It's up to you to make sure your children survive a fire's deadly flames and smoke. Hold regular fire drills in your home. Plan more than one escape route. Teach your children the stop, drop, and roll maneuver if their clothing catches fire, and to never hide from a fire under beds or in closets. That may be their last game of hide and seek.
We got the kid out. He's safe.
Brought to you by the Allstate Network.
The New York Jets' most offensive weapon this afternoon has been Joe Ferguson of the Buffalo Bills. He's been intercepted 4 times. That time Ferguson forced the ball, intending it for Butler, his wide receiver. Jerry Holmes, number 47, the second year back from West Virginia, stepped in front of it. His second interception of the afternoon. Once again, the Jets have the football. They trail by 11.
Richard Todd up there now ready to take the snap. Running backs are evened up for the Jets. Ball at their own 23-yard line. Todd dropping back, full pivot. Now throws to Walker. It's batted up into the air, incomplete. Walker batted it up into the air, and defending Buffalo Bills tried to get to it and could not. Mario Clark was closest, but it is an incompletion, second and 10.
The Bills now anticipating pass. Todd trying to cross them up on first down throwing early, and now the Bills will send in the nickel defense. Walker batted it up. It was almost like a volleyball drill, and Mario Clark had a good shot at it. He's got one interception in the afternoon already. Simpson, who also has an interception, was back there in coverage as well.
Kevin Long is part in the next play. He and Freeman McNeil are the setback. Richard Todd handing it off. And it's second by Long up to the 30-yard line. Pulled down squarely at the 30 by Smirlis.
Pick up of seven.
It'll be third down and 3 yards to go.
Seven carries, 27 yards for Kevin Long in the afternoon. The Jets trying to cross them up. The Bills were thinking pass and playing pass all the way. And that time he managed to pick up 7 yards. So it's third and three and an interesting play call. The Jets have to keep this drive alive. Clock winding down. It'll be under 11 when the ball is snapped.
Durking and Harper in the ball game now for the Jets. Richard Todd dropping back to look. Sets it up and throws on a penalty marker. Goes down. The ball is completed. It's a diving catch by Mickey Schuler up at the 34-yard line. But there's a penalty marker on the play. Holding indicated against the Jets.
Thrown way in the backfield of the New York Jets. Richard Todd was sacked. Good pressure that time by the Buffalo Bills. They play basically that 3-4 defense. Usually you don't get a whole lot of pressure when you do, but that time it was big number 77, Ben Williams, who busted.
Holding number 61, offense, third down.
That's John Roman, the tackle, 6'4", in his sixth year out of Idaho State. So the Jets now have been penalized four times for 35 yards. That was a costly one. It'll bring up third down and 14 to go. And again, the Jets must keep this drive alive. It's 10:45 left to go in the ball game, and you're down by 11.
Jets have the ball on their own 20-yard line. Todd brings him up, wide receivers left and right. Waits for the snap, and he's got it. Richard Todd, plenty of time. Looks, throws left, and it is incomplete. Way across the sideline marker. Intended for Bobby Jones, number 89, but it is 4th and 13 now for the Jets with the ball at their own 20-yard line. 10 minutes, 38 seconds left to play in the game. And the Buffalo Bills leading the New York Jets by a score of 24-13. Well, the punting unit's in.
Now, if you're the New York Jets, you turn it over to your specialty team. You hope that Riddick will maybe cough up the ball or you can force some kind of a fumble. Todd in the second half, not much better than Ferguson, 2 out of 5, 18 yards. Now, when we started, the wind was about 18, 20 miles an hour from the east-northeast. It's still not swirling down there. But both quarterbacks having all sorts of problems.
Cater's in to do the punting. Pacone is dropped back along with Riddick. And Pacone moves up, takes it at the 50, returns to the Jet 45-yard line when he's pulled out. Lou Pacone on the return in the Jet territory, first and 10. So with the score, the Buffalo Bills 24, the New York Jets 13, let's take timeout.
And country roads,
international,
making deliveries, hauling loads,
international,
whatever job you've got to do, the number one name in trucks means saving for you,
international.
Whatever your trucking needs are, International's out to lower your cost of ownership. Right now, you can save thousands of dollars with special year-end price allowances at participating International dealers. And if you do buy before the end of your 1981 tax year, you may also gain a whole year's worth of tax benefits. Ask your International dealer soon just how much you can save. There's never been a better time to buy at International.
Whatever job's got to be done, International can cost you less to run.
Number 1 name in trucks, International.
I think the Cincinnati Bengals have a preference who they entertain next week at Riverfront.
I doubt that they do. Among these two teams, I doubt they would have a preference. The Cincinnati Bengals had such a good season, they don't really care who they play, I should imagine.
Well, let's see. Cincinnati beat the Jets 31-30. Cincinnati beat Buffalo 27-24, so...
Not much to choose. Here we go now. The Buffalo Bills first and 10 at the 45-yard line of the New York Jets. Running backs in and eye. Here's a quick pitch. Taken by Cribbs. He goes to the right side. Across the line of scrimmage. He picked up 5, 10 down the right sideline. 30, 25, 20. Cribbs is gone for a touchdown. Joe Cribbs raced down the sideline after he turned the corner. He was on his way. And the great running back of the Buffalo Bills took it almost out of the stadium, all the way to the wall beyond the end zone. He really turned on the afterburners after he got around the corner and went to the right sideline.
Touchdown! Personal foul! Against the defense!
That was Bob McAwee, the referee, who indicated the personal foul against
Buffalo. Touchdown is good!
Big block thrown by Roosevelt Leakes, number 48.
Unnecessary roughness, number 47 defense.
And then as Lindsey Coleman
was
off to the races, the penalty was called against Jesse Johnson, number 27, the second year former Buffalo out of Colorado. And he just shoved Mr. Cribbs into the retaining wall. Then some of the New York fans showed their lack of class by dousing Mr. Cribbs with a couple of beers.
Conversion attempt coming now. Mickemeyer will attempt it. Matt Robinson holding. It's down, up, and it's good. And so with the score, the Buffalo Bills 31 and the New York Jets 13. Let's take time out.
Each Best Western is delightfully different. And that means a variety of services for you. Yet every Best Western is independently owned. So you'll enjoy the personal attention that comes from pride of ownership. Next time you're looking for a special place to turn in, we've made selecting your 1982 Buick LeSabre easier by making an irresistible offer, the Buick 100% off offer. Buy a LeSabre coupe with a special group of options and get either the designer's accent paint or a Landau vinyl top at no extra charge based on manufacturer's suggested retail price. Or choose between a long padded vinyl top or the designer's accent paint if you buy a LeSabre sedan. On second thought, the choice might not be so easy, but at 100% off, how could you possibly go wrong?
After that New York Jet punt, the Buffalo Bills go 45 yards in one play, and they used 45 seconds. Does that mean Joe Cribbs was running 1 yard a second? In any event, they have just iced the cake a little bit, and they have gone out in front 31-13 with 10:16 left to go in regulation. So the Jets are trailing by 18 points, and some of their fans are headed to the subway here at Shea.
For many of the Jet fans, the football season is over. They have headed for the exits now with Buffalo having had the big play here, and now it'll be Mickemeyer kicking it off. It's been teed up at the 50-yard line with the penalty for the personal foul inflicted. So here is Mickemeyer's kick. Harper and Sohn back there, and Sohn is taking it deep, but it's across the end line as he steps back there. Touchback, first and 10 at the 20-yard line. So the New York Jets get the football, but they get it deep in their own territory, and they're trailing 31-13. The clock says 10 minutes, 11 seconds remain to be played in this game at Shea Stadium, the wild card playoff game in the American Football Conference.
Well, Lindsey, I always wondered, when you had a penalty all the way up to the 50-yard line and you're kicking off, that's a pretty good opportunity in a ball game to try an onside kick or a short kick. Why have your kicker always kick it into the end zone? You know they're going to have it at the 20-yard line. You don't lose that much.
I agree. There's a pass play, and it is completed to Tom Newton. Newton out across the 30-yard line to the 32-yard line, first and 10, good for 12 yards. 11th first down of the ball game for the Jets. Villapiano made the tackle.
Of course, the Jets now have the clock working against them. The Buffalo defense will be guarding against the big play back in the nickel coverage, giving Richard Todd and the Jets the opportunity to work the field, the short field, those little 8, 10, 15-yard pops. Take what the defense will give you.
First down and 10 yards to go. Here's Richard Todd again, dropping back. Thompson goes long to Walker, and it is incomplete. Walker had beaten the last man and dropped it at the 30-yard line.
You know, Lindsey, that's the second one that Walker has dropped in the first quarter as they were coming this way, left to right. In the end zone, he had another one right in the breadbasket and dropped it. So that's two sure touchdown grabs that Walker has had fall out of his grasp. Richard Todd now 14 of 30, 175 yards, three interceptions, but that ball could have been and should have been caught.
He had beaten Simpson.
And also Mario Clark. Mario Clark was number 29. He went to bat the ball away. And in so doing, I think, distracted Wesley Walker, so it all goes for a long incompletion.
Second and 10 at the 32-yard line. Bobby Jones comes to a wide right. Running backs are split for Richard Todd. Todd again retreats now, and he's chased out of the pocket. Still alive, decides he'll keep it and eat it as he gets back to the line of scrimmage for no gain. It'll be third and 10 at the 32-yard line. Bill and they're on the tackle along with Ken Johnson.
So with 9:20 left to go in regulation for the New York Jets, their entire season could come down to this one third down play. You're down by 18 points. You certainly can't give the ball back over to Buffalo, who will run off 2 or 3 minutes on the clock. Bills, by the way, have sacked Richard Todd twice today.
Buffalo, on occasion, gets as many as 7 defensive backs in there now. In a situation like this, it is third down, 10 yards to go. Richard Todd waiting for the snap, and he's got it. Drops back, throws left, and it is complete. Out across the 45-yard line. So that is enough for the first down. Mickey Shula, the tight end, to whom they've been throwing here this afternoon, gets it in for the first down. It's going to be spotted at the 46-yard line, first and 10. 12th first down of the ballgame for the New York Jets. Clock is running with 8.5 minutes remaining to be played in the game. Buffalo is leading 31-13.
Let's talk about Mickey Shuler. He's having such a great afternoon here this afternoon. You wonder where he was the first 16 games and why he wasn't involved in the Jet offense. He's got good hands, good speed.
Todd is driving back again. Throws it to Durkee, and he completes, takes it across the 50-yard line to the 48. So it's a gain of 6 yards on the play. It'll be second and 4 for the Jets. Lucius Sanford made the tackle for Buffalo.
And the Jets are going with a hurry-up offense, no huddle at all.
They don't have to. They're ready to go as soon as the ball is marked. And it is. So Todd steps up there. Already they are deployed left and right. Todd drops it back. Looks again now. Whips it again to Durkee at the 40-yard line. He's got the first down to 38. He's hit down there. It is Lucius Sanford on the tackle along with Filippiano. 13th first down for the Jets again. A no-huddle offense. They're set to go first and 10 at the Buffalo Bills 38-yard line. Wide receivers left and right. Richard Todd angles right and throws, and it is complete to Jones. And Bobby Jones is hit just as he approached the 30-yard line. He was knocked out of bounds. Not enough for the first down. Rufus Benton made the tackle.
This, of course, is reminiscent of what Bud Grant and the Minnesota Vikings did in that Monday night game against the Denver Broncos when they fell behind by about 16, 17 points and went to that hurry-up two-minute offense without the use of auto with about 8.5 minutes left to go and almost pulled out the football game.
Now they do huddle on this play since the clock was stopped on the receiver going out of bounds. It is second down and 2 yards to go, just short of the 30. Richard Todd with his running back split. Angles out to the left side and sets. Now throws it long toward the end zone and in the end zone. Touchdown. Bobby Jones took it and there is in there for the touchdown. Bobby Jones. His second touchdown catch of the year. There's a penalty marker being checked out, but the indication is it's against Buffalo. And it is declined, and so it is a touchdown. McAwee, the referee, indicating that suddenly he'll come as one.
Defensive pass interference, number 26, and it is declined. Touchdown.
Charles Rome, defensive pass interference. It's declined, and it is a touchdown, and we have a conversion attempt coming. Leahy with the boot, and it's good. 7 more points for the Jets. And so the score now is 31-20. Buffalo still leading, and we'll be back in just a moment.
Some of those New York Jet fans that might have headed for the subway, if you're listening on CBS Radio, you might want to head back because your team has just gone 80 yards in 8 plays. They used up 3:08 on the clock, not much time at all, and it's again an 11-point Buffalo advantage, 31-20. Bobby Jones pulled in a scoring strike from Richard Todd of 30 yards, and the Jets will tee it up and kick it off.
Leahy boots it, is bounding downfield over to Riddick's side. He picks it up at the 13, to the 15, to the 20, and Riddick, as he approaches the 25, is swarmed by the Jets and never gets there. It'll be marked at the 23-yard line. First down and 10 yards to go for the Buffalo Bills.
steady downpour is beginning now here at Shea Stadium, which that might be the reason that some of the fans headed to the exits a little bit early.
John Woodring made the first contact and credited with the tackle on that kickoff return.
Well, you can hear the chants of defense now by the New York fans. There are 7:03 left in regulation. The Buffalo Bills have a 31-20 advantage. Obviously, Buffalo would like to keep it on the ground, work on that clock a little bit. But if they use up a minute and a half, 2 minutes or so, and the Jets' defense can stiffen, the Jets would still have 5 minutes with which to work. They scored in 3 minutes, so this game could be a long way from being over. When it is, Jack Buck and Hank Stram are standing by Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia as the Eagles play host to the New York Giants. Wild card action in the NFC. The winner to advance against the San Francisco 49ers.
Al Washington of the Jets was injured on the play and has been escorted off the field. He left under his own power. So now, first and 10 for the Buffalo Bills with the ball at their own 23-yard line. 7 minutes, 3 seconds left to play. Ferguson brings him up in an I formation. Roosevelt leaps ahead of Joe Cribbs, running back, or rather wide receivers left and right. Cribbs tries the left side, and he can't make it. As Kenny Neal got to him first for a loss back at about the 21-yard line. Loss of 2 yards on the play.
Cribbs did a wise thing that time, though, Lindsey. He could have run the ball out of bounds. He saw he was headed for the sideline and just stopped. He knew he was going to get hit and hit hard as the Jets are scratching and clawing and trying to strip him of the football. But rather than go out of bounds and stop the clock, he elected to take the loss and keep that clock winding down.
Jets will be trying to strip him of the football every time he gets it because Cribbs does have the reputation of coughing it up at some critical times. It is second down and 12 at the 21-yard line. Cribbs is the tailback in the I formation, leaks ahead of him. Ferguson with the ball, quick pitch to Cribbs now. He tries the right side. And again, he's cut off with the pass, dives forward, there's a penalty marker. He just got back to the line of scrimmage, to the 21-yard line, but there's a marker to be checked out. So McElwee, the referee, confers with his fellow officials about that flag. Penalty is against Buffalo. So he has not yet enforced it. Moves up to the 21-yard line.
Jets may decline the penalty and keep the down box moving.
They might.
53 on the
little garble. Somebody was tripping. Somebody for Buffalo was tripping, and the penalties declined.
Will Grant, the center, number 53. Keep the down box moving, so it's third down and 12. Clock stops on the penalty, 6:02, so the Jets can get it back with about 5.5 to play.
Big third down play. Crowd is rising to that occasion. They go into the shotgun, Buffalo does. Ferguson waiting for the direct snap. And he's got it. Retreats to look. Runs right. Throws on the run. Incomplete. Intended for Grant. So that'll be fourth down. And the punting unit comes on now to give it up for Buffalo.
So Ferguson now is 17 out of 31. He wisely decided not to try to force the ball too close to Joe Cribbs, who had slid out of the backfield over on the right side. Ferguson, I think, Lindsey, had room to run for the first down if he wanted to. He was chased out of there by Gastineau. Ferguson threw it behind Joe Cribbs, so they'll punt the ball away. Clock stopped on the incompleted pass. The Jets will have good field position and a lot of time.
Cater's in to do the punting. He's standing back on his own 6-yard line. Harper and a single safety standing at his own 43 for the New York Jets.
Boy, would he like to break one right here.
Cater waiting for the snap. Gets it, steps up, gets rid of the football, long, high, spiraling kick. Harper's retreating, has it at his 36, to the 40, heads for the sideline and goes out of bounds at the 42-yard line. 44-yard putt. So now the Jets get the ball in excellent field position, trailing by 11 points, Buffalo leading it 31-20.
Interesting, very judicious working of the clock by the New York Jets. on offense, on the specialty teams, on defense on the specialty teams. Of course, they were aided by a penalty against Buffalo, an incomplete pass, but they only used, Lindsey, 23 seconds from when Buffalo took over possession.
Going out. The Jets are in their huddle. Here they come out of the huddle and up to the line. They're sending Wesley Walker to the right side. Richard Todd with the football. Short drop. Now runs out of the pocket. And he's hit. He's sacked. Way back there about the 31-yard line. Did the ball get away? Smirlis apparently got to him.
Joe Fields, number 65, the center, seven-year man out of Widener in Pennsylvania, the man that fell on the loose football. Todd was blindsided from the left side, or actually from his right side. Coming in there was Smirlis, as Lindsey said, to strip him of the football, and Fields, fortunately for the New York Jets, got it back.
Second and 18, back at the 34-yard line now. Richard Todd throwing, and it is incomplete, intercepted, and a penalty marker. A penalty marker on the interception. And interference has been called. Interference has been called against Buffalo. It was picked off by Mario Clark. But interference has been called on Buffalo.
You don't think there's some bad blood?
Defensive pass interference, number 29.
This is Mario Clark. You don't think there's some bad blood between these two teams? Isaiah Robertson was in there. He was upset at the call. Chuck Knox came out about 3 or 4 yards on the field. And Mark Gastineau, the defensive coordinator.
First and 10 at the Buffalo 47.
Mark Gastineau, defensive end, came out there to try to arouse this offensive unit of the New York Jets.
So now the Jets have the ball in Buffalo territory. 5 minutes, 8 seconds left to play in the game. Todd throwing completely to Shula. Mickey Shula's inside the 30. He's down to the 29-yard line, first and 10. The tight end, Shuler, took the pass. Quick release. No huddle plays. Jets are up there ready to go, first and 10 at the 29-yard line. Todd takes a look. See that everybody's set. Wide receivers, he's got it. Dropping back now. Throws up the middle. Complete. The tight end again has it. Shuler inside the 15-yard line, down to the 13-yard line. First and 10 at the 13. Shuler taking it, stopped by Steve Freeman.
Same play, they came right back to it. Shuler wide open, the big tight end over the middle, number 82. He's having some kind of a career here this afternoon. No catches as he came in, the four-year man out of Penn State, and another one.
The complete over to Gaffney at the 7-yard line. Derek Gaffney took it and went right out of bounds at the 7-yard line. It's going to be second down and 4 yards to go. Jets ball at the Buffalo 7. Clock stopped, of course, when Gaffney went out of bounds. 4 minutes, 18 seconds remaining to be played in the game. Gaffney comes out. Bobby Jones comes in at a wide receiver for the New York Jets. Buffalo is leading 31-20. The Jets are driving here in the fourth quarter. Todd bending in to take the snap. Goes to a high count. Now he's got the ball, dropping back. Todd is hit. He's sacked. Back at the 15-yard line. Never had a chance. Loss of 8 on the play. Rufus Best got to him.
Third-year man out of South Carolina State. He had one interception. He came in from the right side, unimpeded. Shuler, the tight end, missed the block. And Todd was lucky he had a good grasp on the football. Otherwise, he would have coughed it up. It's back at the 15.
Third and 12 now at the 15-yard line. Todd's got the ball. Back to look. Steps up. Evades the tackler. Throws it, and it is complete. Taken by Bobby Jones. He went out of bounds at the 1 yard line. Ball got away after he had hit the sideline marker. So it's going to be first and goal at the 1 yard line for the Jets. Steve Freeman was the defender there. Bobby Jones was the receiver.
It's just about the length of the football shy of the goal line. Todd looked for a moment like he might have run. The ball almost picked off by Charles Rome, number 26, who went for the ball instead of Bobby Jones. And it is all the way down, well, just about the length of the football.
Scott Jerking is in there now. Newton is in there. Todd's getting the line. Kevin Long is in there as well. Todd takes a look around, waiting for the snap now. Out with the ball, Kevin Long. Touchdown! Touchdown for Kevin Long as he broke the plane of the goal line. And the Jets are on the scoreboard once again. Pandemonium at Shea Stadium.
A very impressive couple of minutes by the New York Jets after that 45-yard touchdown run by Joe Cribbs with 10:16 left to go in the ballgame. It was an 18-point Jet deficit. They have now scored two touchdowns and pulled to a within 31-24.
Leahy kicking. Ryan puts it down. Leahy boots it up, and it's good. So now the Jets are trailing by 4 points, 3 minutes, 44 seconds left to play. Let's pause 5 seconds for stations to identify themselves on the CBS Radio Network.
You're in tune with NFL football here on WROW, Albany.
This is Lindsey Nelson with Jim Kelly at Shea Stadium. Rufus Best of the Buffalo Bills is down and is getting attention from the training staff. The Bills are still leading in the ballgame. They have led throughout, but now it is 31-27. 3 minutes, 44 seconds left to play, and the Jets are getting an ovation from their fans here at Shea. Best is still getting attention. He's down there about the 10-yard line, apparently injured on the conversion attempt, on the made conversion.
Lindsey, this stadium is rocking and socking right now. They are actually physically shaking the stands over across the way. And, of course, the Buffalo Bills will get it back. The Jets have scored 14 unanswered points in a little under 4 minutes. There are 3 minutes and 44 seconds left to go. And the Bills, if they win this one, you have to say, will be extremely lucky. They'll escape Shea Stadium. They had a 24-0 lead. They led by 11 several times. They led by 18 points once. Right now they're clinging precariously to that 4-point lead. Of course, it's out of field goal range as far as the Jets are concerned. But the Buffalo Bills, I would think, Lindsey, would have to be thinking, hey, let's get it into field goal range so that if the Jets do come back and score a touchdown, the very least we'll have is an overtime situation.
Buffalo Bills now are thinking that the New York Jets will try the onside kick so that they are deployed up there with 9 men very close to the restraining line. Only one man deep at all, and Leahy, of course, has teed the ball up at the 35-yard line, so we'll see how the New York Jets play it. 3 minutes, 44 seconds can be a long time.
You think you'll see an onside kick? I think they'll kick it deep. I think they'll concentrate on their defense, which has been so effective, which is tied with 57 points, allowing the fewest in the fourth quarter, rely on the defense, not give Buffalo good field position.
Curtis Brown is the lone deep man, and he's standing at his own 6-yard line. Leahy takes a look around, says he's ready, and here comes Leahy. And they boot it deep. I beg your pardon, they try the onside kick, but it is picked up by the Buffalo Bills, and it is returned. Villafiano got it, and he returned it to about the 40-yard line. Took the big swing, but then suddenly cut and tried the onside kick. Villafiano fielded the ball and returned it to the 40-yard line. So the Bills get the ball in excellent field position.
The 11-year veteran out of Bowling Green, a former Falcon, had his first interception on the year this year. Villapiano with a good hand, the concerned Chuck Knox, head coach of the Buffalo Bills. 3:37 left on the clock, first and 10 Buffalo at their own 40-yard line. They'll work on the clock, but I would certainly think they'll try to also work down into Mickamar field goal range.
Buffalo Bills, 10 wide receivers left and right, split the running backs for Joe Ferguson. This crowd is alive at Shea Stadium. Ferguson calling starting signals now. He's got the ball. Gives it off to Cribbs. He tries the left side. It's piled up when he gained at most 1 yard. Neal was in there. So was Marty Lyons. Call it second down and 9 yards to go with the ball at the 41-yard line.
14 carries, 81 yards for Joe Cribbs. Remember, 45 of those yards came the last time Buffalo scored on a 45-yard touchdown run by Joe Cribbs.
Buffalo Bills are in no hurry. They are convening the huddle now. The 30-second clock is down to 15 just now as they come out of the huddle and up to the line. Game clock shows 3 minutes, 5 seconds left to play in this game. We'll have the automatic timeout, of course, at the 2-minute warning, which will be coming up very shortly. Dropping back is Ferguson. Takes a look. Chased out of the pocket. Throws on the run. And it is incomplete. Over at the sideline. Ferguson was hit as he unloaded the football, but it is an incompletion. So it's going to be third down and 9 yards to go. Big third down play coming here.
Mark Gastineau, Abdul Salam putting all kinds of pressure on Joe Ferguson, who's having a very rough afternoon after the first half. He is 17 of 32 now, 267 yards, two touchdowns, but four interceptions.
Clock was stopped with 2:52 remaining on that incompletion. It is third down. 9 yards to go at the 41-yard line, and here come the Buffalo Bills. Ron Jesse is in a wide right now. Three wide receivers in the ballgame. They're in a shotgun. Looking for a completion on third down to keep the drive alive. Ferguson's got the ball. Sets down and throws, and it is incomplete. Incomplete, and now it'll bring on the punting unit, and the Buffalo Bills will have to give it up. Jerry Holmes covering defensively there for the Jets. And so the punting unit is on for the Bills.
And
2:47 on the clock.
Right, 2:47, Lindsey. And, of course, the last two passes have been incomplete, so the clock has stopped twice. Now, Harper, number 42, is back. He fumbled the opening kickoff, which led to a 7-0 Buffalo advantage. Obviously, right now, there is some concern among Walt Michaels and the Jets coaches. They would like him very much to hang on to that football, maybe get out of bounds, stop the clock, set up the Jets in good field position.
Greg Cater is in to do the punting for the Buffalo Bills. Bruce Harper is standing back at his own 22-yard line. Cater, hands outstretched, is waiting for the snap. Still waiting. Now he gets it. Gets the kick away. Harper is chased back. It's a high spiraling kick. He's all the way back to the 9-yard line. To the 10, to the 15. Back to the 20-yard line and dives across. Stopped there, 45-yard punt. So now the Jets get the ball. They trail by 4 points. We have 2:36 to play. It's first and 10 at the 20-yard line.
Of course, the Jets will work the clock. They've got the two-minute warning coming up. They don't have to use their two remaining timeouts. They have scored touchdowns on their last two possessions. Richard Todd, a very shaky beginning, but he has hit on his last nine consecutive passes, and he has brought the Jets to within four.
Jets are back there in their huddle now, convening the green jerseys. Break the huddle, come up to the line. Richard Todd brings him up. Scott Durkin is in that backfield right now. Todd retreats and throws, and it is complete to Shuler. Shuler's up to the 40, the 45, the 49-yard line. Mickey Shuler, the tight end. It's first and 10 for the Jets. And the Jets, in a no-huddle formation, are ready to go as soon as the ball is marked ready for play. First down and 10 yards to go. Jets at their own 49. Todd looks left, he looks right. He has his running back split. Todd drops back. Looks and throws to Shula. Incomplete. Overthrew Shula up the middle again. Terry O'Clark trying to get to it, could not. Rufus Best trying to get to it, could not. Second down and 10 yards to go at the 49-yard line.
Same play that they have run. This time Shuler was cut off at the pass. He actually complained afterwards that he might have been held. You're looking for an MVP right now. If the Jets would win, how about Mickey Shuler? Seven catches, 132 yards, and one touchdown. Clock is stopped on the incompleted pass, so the Jets get a break there. 2:04 to go.
Bobby Jones is in there, the wide receiver. He comes out of the huddle to a wide right. Buffalo leading 31-27. The Jets in possession here late in the ballgame. Richard Todd waiting for the snap. He's got it. Dropping back. Looks for Bobby Jones. And it's complete inside the 40-yard line. At the 38. He turned and went out of bounds to stop the clock. And we have reached less than 2 minutes now. Clock was stopped as he went across the sideline marker. 1:59 showing on the clock. So that is the automatic timeout. And with the score, Buffalo 31, the New York Jets 27. Let's take time out.
They were big and fast and hadn't lost a touch football game in 2 years. Then right before the kickoff, they suggested Michelob Light for the winners, to which you replied, "You guys would do that for us?"
It's Michelob Light. There's nothing quite like that rich, smooth taste of Michelob Light. Michelob Light, 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 Michelob Light
team did it. You battled them right down to that last and longest yard. For pride? Well, maybe, but mostly for the rich, smooth taste of Michelob Light. Here's to the winners.
Michelob Light,
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis.
Richard Todd has now hit on 12 consecutive passes. He's 25 of 42, 339 yards. He's been intercepted three times. Lindsey, they're doubling the outside man. Thus, the middle is wide open for Mickey Schuler and the backs most of the afternoon. That seems to be where Richard Todd is content to work. If he doesn't get greedy, he's got 159. He's got two timeouts left. He only needs to drive the Jets down 40 yards. What you don't want to do is throw into double coverage. You're over the middle and maybe have a linebacker that you don't see pick it off.
First and 10. Jets ball at the Bills 39-yard line. Wesley Walker's in a wide right. Todd dropping back. Takes a look left, and he's going to be sacked. He's pulled down at the 49-yard line. Smirlis got to him. Loss of 10 on the play will make it second and 20. At the 49.
That's the fifth sack for a minus 31 yards by the Buffalo Bills. Came at a key time. The clock continues to wind down.
No huddle alignment. Todd with the ball retreating again. This time unloads it. And it's an incompleted pass. It's a short hop. Incompleted out there about the 45-yard line. Trying to get it to Durkee. Cush was covering defensively. It's going to be third down and 20 at the 49-yard line.
Actually, it's probably a break for the Jets that was incomplete because it wouldn't have picked up much yardage and it would have worked against the clock. New York then would have had to use one of their timeouts. As it is, the clock stops with 1:43 and New York possession, they're down by four. They've got to get it down to about the 28-yard line of the Buffalo Bills.
Derek Gaffney comes into the ball game. He comes out of the huddle to a wide left. Wesley Walker's in a wide right. Harper and Durkee are the setbacks. Dropping back is Todd. Looks now and throws, and it's complete. It's taken at the 30 and carried on down to the 22-yard line. A first down. A first down for the Jets as Gaffney gathered it in and raced to the 21 for a first and 10. And a Buffalo man is down, but he's up quickly. He is apparently all right. Ball is spotted at the 22-yard line, first and 10. It was Jeff Nixon who was down, lying motionless. He got up and is okay. Here come the Jets again now. Clock says 1 minute 11 seconds left to play in the game. Richard Todd retreats, sets up, puts it up down toward the end zone, and it's incomplete. Batted by Jeff Nixon. Wesley Walker's the man for whom it was intended. That was just sort of that alley-oop pass that he was going to put down there with the hope that Walker could run underneath it. And instead, it was batted by Nixon out of bounds, and so it's going to be now second down. 10 yards to go at the 22-yard line.
Kind of an unusual pass pattern that time. A strange call by Richard Todd. You're working the middle. You're working the sideline. You get a little greedy. You throw it up top. You risk the interception right there. What you got was a break. It went incomplete, and you stopped the clock.
1 minute, 4 seconds left to play in the game. The running backs are split. Todd moves up, and now he is calling something of the attention of the officials.
Wants a dry football.
That's exactly what he wants.
You want an optimist? Pat Leahy, working on the extra points, limbering up, trying to get that toe warmed up over on the Jets sideline.
The Bills lead it 31-27, a four-point advantage, 1 minute, 4 seconds left to play. Second and 10, Jets at the 22, and the snap is bobbled for the moment, a penalty marker thrown. Referee's flag is thrown in there.
I believe it'll be motion against the Jets. Todd started back before the snap.
There was a snap on the offer.
Illegal snap on the offense. That's a 5-yarder.
Actually, the Jets were lucky, Lindsey, on the illegal snap that there wasn't a fumble and that Buffalo didn't recover.
Exactly. 5-yard penalty is marked off. Jets are up there ready to go, waiting for referee McElwee to complete his report. Gaffney has come back into the ball game. Second and 15 at the 27-yard line. Richard Todd waiting for the snap. He's got it. Back to set up. Over the middle and incomplete. It is intended for Harper, in and out of his hands. Third and 15 at the 27.
Couple of 42s up against each other. 42, Harper for the New York Jets, Rod Cush. 42 for the Buffalo Bills, second-year man out of Nebraska, Omaha. And then the ball was deflected from Bruce Harper, and Wesley Walker had a shot at it. While we have a moment, let's tell you that today's broadcast has been sponsored by Denny's Restaurants, by International Harvester Trucks, and by Buick and your local Buick dealer. Our spotter, Hal Schiff, our statistician, Ray Stallone.
Third down and 15 yards to go for the Jets at the 27-yard line of the Buffalo Bills. Richard Todd calling starting signal. He's got the ball retreating. Sets up, looks, throws down the middle, and Walker can't get it as it is picked off. Penalty marker is thrown. It was picked off by Buffalo at the 4-yard line, but there was a marker on the play.
Okay.
Freeman got the ball. Steve Freeman holding against Buffalo. Holding against Buffalo. Walker was streaking for the end zone. Ball was picked off, but holding was detected against Buffalo, and the Jets are being consulted now.
It was Mario Clark who did it. He got his arm on the intended receiver, Wesley Walker. We'll check the referee in just a second.
Holding, number 29, defense, automatic first down.
At the 22-yard line, it is first and 10. Automatic first down on Mario Clark's holding. 47 seconds left to play in this game. Buffalo leading 31-27. Richard Todd has them up there, wide receivers left and right. Todd with the ball now, dropping back. Unloads it, and it's complete inside the 20-yard line to the 18. Scott Dierking took it, but the clock is running. Gain of 4 yards on the play, makes it second down and 6 yards to go at the 18.
Lindsey, you would think that Buffalo would blitz a little bit more, not give Todd quite as much time, at least send one of the linebackers in.
Todd is retreating the setup. Goes to the end zone. Shula, incomplete. Stopped at 24 seconds left to play in the game. Shula covered by Steve Freeman. Deep in the end zone. It'll be third and 6 at the 18-yard line.
And while we have another second, our engineer Keith, the big one, Park, our producer David Kerman, Frank Miller, the executive producer for CBS Radio Sports, I am gathering we are going quickly to Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia, where we'll join Jack Buck and Hank Stram, the Eagles playing host to the Giants, in 24 thrill-packed seconds.
Third down, 6 yards to go for the Jets. Here they come out of the huddle and up to the line. They held the ball at the 18-yard line of the Buffalo Bills. Wide receivers left and right, Richard Todd leaning in and waiting for the snap. He's got it. Back to set up now. Takes a look. Throws it up the middle. And it's caught, but only down to the 11-yard line. It'll be enough for another first down. Scott Dierking and the Jets take a timeout. Jets take a timeout. Scott Dierking took it to the 11-yard line. It'll be first and 10. 14 seconds on the clock. Let's give our stations a chance for a message. We'll be back in just a moment.
Has problems, that is true, but here's our season's wish for you. That peace and goodwill just might yet work. Season's cheer from the CBS Radio Network.
With that word of cheer from CBS News correspondent Charles Osgood, greetings of the season from the Spectrum Six. Pat O'Brien, Roger Wilkins, Joe Sobrad, Jack Newfield, Marianne Means, and Kevin Phillips. Holiday greetings, too, from Ida LeShad, Marshall Lowe, Bob Keeshan, and Lee Jordan. From Steve Birnbaum and Steve Scheuer, Shep Campbell, Nick Seitz, and Jack Sampson. And from everyone else at the CBS Radio Network.
31-27, the Buffalo Bills backed up at the shadow of their own end zone, looking at their own goalpost right now. 14 seconds left to go. The Jets have the football. They need 11 yards to go ahead for the first time, the only time in this football game.
Richard Todd brings them up there with a running back split. Harper and Dierking are the running backs, both good receivers. Todd now retreats, sets it up and looks, throws, and it's incomplete. Underthrew Shula. His tight end, but he was out about the 3-yard line, underthrew him. Clock says 10 seconds left to play in this game. Second and 10 at the 11-yard line. Will the Jets be able to take it in and get an exciting victory here to advance in the playoffs? Or will their season die right here? They have it second down. 10 yards to go at the 11-yard line of the Buffalo Bills, who have led all day long. Here comes Derek Gaffney back into the ballgame now with the next play. Bobby Jones is coming off. Here come the Jets out of the huddle up to the line. Wesley Walker coming to a wide right. Gaffney to a wide left. Richard Todd bending in and calling starting signals. Richard Todd has the ball, angles out to the left side. Looks, throws, intercepted at the 2-yard line. Return to the 5, to the 10. Buffalo gets the ball at the 10-yard line. And so that gives them the ball with 2 seconds showing on the clock. Picked off by Charles Rome. Rome picked it off and returned it to the 10-yard line. And so now, to all intents and purposes, the game has ended and the season has ended, although the offensive unit comes slowly on for Buffalo. The defensive unit comes slowly on for the Jets. The ball is spotted at the 10-yard line, the point to which it was returned. Referee McAlee talking to Ferguson, the quarterback for the Buffalo Bills, and saying, now, come on out on the field. We have 2 seconds on the clock, which can't start until the snap. Bill Simpson, it was, who got the football. It was Simpson who got the football instead of Rome. And he has carried the ball off the field. Still 2 seconds on the clock.
Lindsey, interestingly enough, the game ends as it began on a New York Jet turnover.
Does indeed. That's just the way it began. McAlee is still saying, get some people out here on the field. We can't start the clock until the snap. 2 seconds, that will end it. Ferguson is in there now. He takes the snap, hits the deck. Clock runs to 1 second, no seconds, and the game is over. So the Buffalo Bills have won the ball game 31-27 and will advance to the playoff round playing Cincinnati. Let's give our stations a chance for a message. We'll be back in just a moment.
This is Gene King for your Better Business Bureau. When you go Christmas shopping this year, make sure to compare warranties. You see, purchasing products with good warranties will ensure that you don't give gifts that will need costly repairs soon after the holiday season. And when comparing, first determine if the warranty is a full or limited one. Now, a full warranty means that if the product breaks, it'll be repaired at no charge within a reasonable time. And if it hasn't been fixed after a reasonable number of tries, you can get a replacement or a refund. A limited warranty means that you get less protection than under a full warranty. For example, the parts may be included, but you may have to pay for the labor. And last but not least, find out when the warranty period starts and also how long it lasts. A consumer tip from this station and your Better Business Bureau.
Lindsey, very quickly, we saw really two different football games. One that saw Buffalo jump out in front 24-0, and the second one won by the Jets 27-7. But when you total it all up, it's still 31 for the Buffalo Bills, 27 for the Jets.
Turned out to be an exciting finish, and of course the Buffaloes came on with that interception, and now they advance in the playoff round.
So Buffalo-Cincinnati next week at Riverfront Stadium in Cincinnati. Both quarterbacks intercepted 4 times. A wild one here at Shea. There you have it. Today's AFC first-round playoff game between the New York Jets and the Buffalo Bills has ended with a final score. Buffalo 31, the Jets 27. Don't forget, there's more NFL action coming up next on most of these same CBS Radio Network stations, the New York Giants and the Philadelphia Eagles in just about 1 minute. Now for Lindsey Nelson, Brent Musburger, and Dick Stockton, I'm Jim Kelly saying so long from Shea Stadium in New York for CBS Radio Sports.